and the birds and the bees, if you know what I mean. Then tune in to Real Talk for real answers this and every Monday night from 9 to 12 with Lady Cleo and Daddy Rude, only on Styles 96 FM. Real Talk, where we unearth what's real and not what's ideal.
Yep, 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 yep. Good night, good night, good night, ladies and gentlemen. Good night. You know, tonight at the 25th of June, of July, yeah, 25th of July, eh? No, I really said me I mix up the months, then, you know, I guess something just went with the thought a while ago. Yeah, it's the 25th of July, and on Saturday, it's Hallelujah anyhow. I'm more all a reason with the people and panda event there, because the tickets are out, pre-sold 1,000, and we have a number of ticket outlets, right? So we need the people them to make up their mind of getting the early tickets, because on the night, which happened several times, persons turned up at the event and still asking if it's $1,000. It happens every year, so I'm not may I try if I say. The thing about it is that there's a reason why it's pre-sold. There are limited amount of tickets for pre-sold, right? And you need to get the tickets at the outlets them. Usually persons wait till like all the Friday and up to even 7 o'clock on Saturday when the event starts. Persons are going to the ticket outlets in anticipation. It happened to each year. Wherein say we have to replenish the outlets them, or a check from one a slower outlet to get the tickets to a faster moving outlet. So I'm just asking you, ladies and gentlemen that are listening, and who have plans to come to the event, to get your tickets now at the different outlets, and we have been advertising them every half an hour, right? Wild Cave Pharmacy, Super Care Pharmacy, Miss Mac Shop in Bonebrook, the ice cream shop just out by the crossroad at Bonebrook there, and many other locations, right? So I need persons to really take them thing there more serious. Well, I know you take it serious, but deal with them earlier, right? Because the last day we everybody busy trying to get just the final touches for the performance show, and it's for you, the listeners. A lot of persons come to me every year and ask if it's just a show I want to secular. I said no, but you know, if you are not interested and you talk about stage show you want with care stage show, I said get a ticket for your mommy for this particular show. We have fan fusion for you already. What more you want? Right, and you can come as well, but you know, buy your grandma a ticket, buy your mommy a ticket, you know, somebody who you know definitely would like to be there, and you want to treat them, you know, Father's Day gone, Mother's Day gone, but you still want to, you know, make them have some fun. So nothing wrong with that. So people, early tickets, and we even had that early bird thing where we had like $800 for a ticket, etc. So it's not like we didn't make an effort to make it easier for you to be at the event. All right, so I want the people to know, say we only have like 5 days left for you to get your tickets, and it's a limited amount and tickets are going, and I need you to just bear with me. On the last day, if you go to a ticket outlet and there's no tickets, you just have to come at the gate and get it. The other thing now regarding chairs, we're gonna arrange the chairs on the corridor as usual, and we are bringing chairs that are provided to us by the venue owners, right? So please may I ask you, if you're traveling with a family, of argument's sake, 4 people and one of them is a small child, put the child in their lap, you know, nobody got to say the child have a seat at them own and them thing there. So at least somebody else who comes, probably another mother with their child, can have a seat and their child can be seated in their laps, as against everyone wanting a chair, and then you get all crazy and the promoter, Lord have mercy, yours truly. And so when I provide chairs for, yes, more than enough chairs. I think they have like about maybe 500 or so chairs. So, you know, more than enough people, and not so much here. No, sir. And not so much here, we get a year time. But it's the same amount of chairs that are in the auditorium right now. If you go on in there and look, it's the same amount of chairs that's going to be made available for our patrons for the event. So nobody not supposed to cost me for that particular reason. I get it every year anyway, but you know, I'm explaining that you don't person don't usually, when you go in the auditorium and the auditorium full of chair, nobody not say nothing. But when them come, hallelujah, anyone, and I the same cheer them cost me. I'm just saying, just be courteous, ladies and gentlemen, just be courteous and be there on time. And if you have small kids, just put the elders first and kids first, then, and elders if anything. Now, but I see somebody walking with a grandma and thing, and you just feel say, nah, them fit turn up because they want a part of your family. We're all one big family. Anything where styles keep, it's a family thing, right? So it's something that we must have. Oh, so Daddy Road, second time gone already, and second minute, what that? Okay. Oh, Charm, it's working now. Me know you advertise your thing. Phone line now work. It'll work now, Charm. Yeah. Daddy Styles fixed it. But, you know, again, one other thing we want to talk about too. Businesses in general and marketing and advertising. A lot of persons don't know because we have not been pushing it, but there's an advertising special going on now for small business that are just starting up, entrepreneurs that are just starting up, and it's only $5,000 for the entire month. So you need to get in touch with the office at 286-9216. That's 286-9216. Talk to Sandra, talk to Sue on 286-9216. So persons who are starting up their businesses and you want to advertise, it's only $5,000 per month, right? And they'll give you the details as it relates to what you get for that $5,000 per month. I even encourage some persons to double it as well, $10,000 per month, you know, and they have done so. But talk to Sandra, talk to Sue on 286-9216. Yep, that's it for me for now, for some amount of housekeeping. Good morning.
Anyways, are you alone at us tonight?
No, me just have to talk about a little bit of something, because me know say, you normally, you know, want to take over the thing. Hey, you know say dog bark off of what they don't know, right? And what they not used to.
Now bring it in there. We can't even tell.
How happened?
Me hear you.
You didn't hear me?
Yes, me hear you.
How am I say?
And you were off for me. Too much bad company.
What me did you say? Can't remember what me say. What me say?
It's all right. Now I thought make you there. Yes, yeah.
People.
What are
you? Hey, I never was a feminine neighbor dog then could have bark.
I lied. You didn't dog then bark up everything will move.
No. Till
that is
tonight.
Not true.
Till tonight.
You know, yeah,
I wonder.
Be careful, you know. I'm gonna be careful of you as of tonight.
You know, you know when the talk with them say if you're not wife for the yard, if the dog don't know you.
Thank you, Jesus.
You say dog know you?
No, dog don't know me. Dog for me. Thank you, Jesus. No, I know me.
So
yeah, we kidding, well,
That's one of the ways now where a woman can know if a man, the man a do the thing and the woman a come at the yard. Cause if you are matey,
seriously?
I guess so.
You say dog don't know matey.
If
you're
no, I don't tell you now. Say that I want if you find out what I go on, because if the dog are back off far, then she not declare. But if the dog walk in tail and
thank you, Jesus, we don't care.
You know, say something wrong. I want to ask this question though before getting at the Vox Pop, because it's kind of similar, related to the Vox Pop. One of our listeners and me have all a reason since there. And me not agree. Me not really agree with what she has said. Straight up. I'm a friend and me can't agree with her tonight. My thing is, she said, why Bossy asleep, pretty much. Or earlier in the day, Bossy asleep. You know, time hot and things, so Bossy lay down asleep.
Today?
Yeah.
Okay.
And him, you know, in brief alone. And in brief up on the wrong side. So, you know.
Hold on. He might come from somewhere or he was in the house. All along.
Hold on, Adrian. We can't answer. Hold on, Adrian. Eh?
Did you get to find out if he was in the house all along or
no.
Somewhere he come from?
Hold on, before I get into all of that, I get a bad up. Say, boy, I move like me a liar. Because, what? People tell me something straight up. Straight up. I want both the brethren them and the sister in them view upon this. If a man briefed upon the wrong side, nothing of that.
No, that depends, man.
What it depend upon? It can't depend upon nothing.
It depends on the kind of brief that I first
kind of, no, brief
it
or brief.
It depends when he leave
brief
the
or brief.
It depends if him there were all along. It depends on a whole heap of things.
No,
because if
honestly,
I road him, I come from a shell of him clothes and go later.
Straight up, I think she's so cross. Yeah. For him, the home, I must go in, go there. Actually, the real thing about it is that she told me that he come home, right? And he breathed up on the wrong side.
May I take one picture with him, right? Because you know, when he wake up, I'm going to say, hey, I'm going to say, boy, I lie, may I take a picture at it. You see, if I'm a night and get up, go early morning, I can't see with him, I can't see probably with him, I don't see good, but. Eh?
No, but me can't agree with her because she begs.
So when right? People are up on the wrong side, I don't listen yet, Jessina.
Well, here's my question to her. Right? If before now she did see him brief.
That is it.
Right, so if you know what kind of evidence that because that no
so
mean
that
no.
That means say for the whole day, him not use the bathroom and nothing for his brief. Look here, yes, he put that on in. So, me, I go try go back in my box and remember if I was awake when he was getting dressed, if him get dressed in a yes, and
no.
If the light never died at home.
No. Me there one restaurant last week, Friday, I think, to be exact. And a big man did it, and him shirt up on the wrong side. Right? And it's a lunchtime. Shirt upon the wrong side. Me no bother say nothing to him.
I say make for wear.
Me say me no bother say nothing to him because me know his shirt me for wear upon the wrong side. And when
I
went
with so and somebody put on his shirt in that. Look here.
Me I try to tell you say.
Eh? And somewhere him go probably in the bathroom and put on back in shirt in that. Yes. Me I tell you because if him work somewhere, somebody at some point I go say, Bossy, your shirt upon the wrong side.
No, but what me I tell you say, if it happened to your shirt where you're supposed to be obvious, why can't happen to your brief?
No, sir.
Or underpants.
Something. Underpants.
No, nothing wrong with that.
Let me say good night to everybody. Everybody, good night. Whether you're online, whether you're on,
he was,
whether you're on the text line.
Let me see what five.
Oh, say so was out five, having six, fun.
Six. He was out having fun out the road. Don't blame her to be mad. When I say, when I say. There isn't a possibility, but why we have to go to the possibility? Why we can't?
The human mind, that
is. No, the reality is the man breathed upon the underpants and.
Somebody by the text and say my run up it.
Simple. Right? The man breathed upon the wrong side. Him can simply put it on just that way in the morning when he left.
I respond for him dead.
and him run up it.
If you dead, I'm afraid for the wrong side for 3 days.
Or something dead.
Or something dead.
You know? When we get back from the break, I'm going to tell you a real life story. Not a bar talk. I'm going to share it with my sister in since day two. We happened to a bridge in our mind.
Well, I'm not ready already.
Yeah, we started. We always start a quarter past the hour. So, at 10:30, we're going to have part two with that lady that we spoke to last week by popular request. And she agrees. She agreed to come on board with us this week again to continue. Because we have to do it in a little bit of rush last week. It's now 9:30, ladies and gentlemen. And the time is brought to you by VJ Printing Services. We'll soon forward.
Architects, draftsmen, and surveyors, get your drawings printed in high-quality professional standards. We can satisfy your printing needs. Whether it is for presentation to your clients or for submitting building and subdivision application, make it VJ Printing Services. Whether drawing by hand or with computer-aided softwares, we will plot your negatives and print the copies as you need. We do high-quality white paper printing that is water-resistant and never fades, unlike traditional blueprint. For more information, call VJ Printing at 893-2266.
The biggest hardware sale in Portland is on Wednesday, July 20th to Saturday, July 30th. Every single item on sale. Hardware and household supply. Builders Depot, Bryan's Bay. Builders Depot, Bryan's Bay. Everything must go. 10 days of sale. Wednesday, July 20th to Saturday, July 30th. All items are on sale. Need hardware supply? Come to Builders Depot, Bryan's Bay, Portland 20. This one is big. 10 solid days. Every item on sale. Hardware supplies, household supplies, Builders Depot, everything must go.
Smart.
Quick.
Yo, DJ.
Smart. Yo, my dad. A whole heap of money I man spend on that event, yeah, I know. So me have to make sure it promote proper.
Yo, nothing. Link Styles FM bought them summer burner package.
Summer burner package. I wanna.
5 grand, 1 week party promo shillings. 10 grand, 2 week party promo shillings. Mr. Ads, mentions, interview, giveaway, straight styling. 2869216 or 4395160. Link them now.
No.
Styles FM summer bun up package. Conditions apply.
Movement presents River Dub, the big show at Rio Grande, Portland. It's on July the 30th. It's a free event. And Dwayne Simpson will be there. Kelly Saw will be there. Ayara will be there on the turntable. Gabriel Selassie, Kingston Dub Club. Wally more. Remember, we say it again, it's a free event. Be there. Are you square? Yes, what I'm saying. Refreshment on sale.
Hey, it's not a dream. It's not a dream anymore. Hallelujah, anyhow. The third edition. Styles FM presents Hallelujah, anyhow. In Portland, Portland Town, yo. Portland Town High School Ground comes alive. July the 30th. You got to be there. Featuring Lieutenant Stitchy.
I will do the number. I will do the number.
Hey, the great George Knows. Keisha Bear. Sister Bat. And of course, Minister Mark Ricketts from out of Canada will be there. Yes, alongside Lamar Ari. And you know, our singing sensation on Styles FM every Sunday, Michaela Benjamin. And of course, yours truly, Heavy D, will be there from the Styles FM crew. Admission, 1,000 pre-sold, 1,200 at the gate. Children under 12, 500 at the gate. Host by Reverend Lewis, Pastor Lindsay, and Sister Victoria. Gates open 5 p.m. Showtime, 7 p.m. sharp. You can't miss it. Hallelujah, anyhow. Adopt me, I said. One more time. Hallelujah, anyhow.
The
Tickets for Hallelujah Anyhow are available at these locations: Rightway Pharmacy Royal Mall, Bombrook Ice Cream Shop, Supercare Pharmacy Bridge Street, YK's Pharmacy Upstairs Singer, Shoppers Pride Supermarket Buff Bay, Miss Mac One Stop Mini Mart Bombrook, K&D Variety Hector's River, Seaview Discount Center 14 Harbor Street, and VNC International Travel Consultants 17 Harbor Street, Juta Building. Remember, tickets are only $1,000 pre-sold, so get them now.
All right, we
are back.
And me say me not gonna share a thing with you know.
Yeah,
to one of my brethren.
Share
it. Similar to what with this brethren, you know, cause me not really see that maybe not even realize it on the wrong side. Yes, Denise, thank you very much. See, not no wrong if him brief the on the wrong side. It happens, so.
Nice. Him not fit. Whereas if I were meticulous man, when me know say always a pre or him do him thing.
Yeah, but yeah, try find some sit now. I'm glad for that. I'm glad for that. But this happened. This is a real thing. This is not a bar talk. Virgin of mine, big man, so elder for me. A couple of years ago, him I tell you a situation where happened to him, where him really and truly did go up on the ends, and mash a work. So when he left the end zone and go on back, take off his clothes, lie down. Still nothing to the bridge in the time hot and just lie down and depend in bed and watch TV. Him said notice him woman coming at the house, coming at the room, talk to him a little bit, turn back and ask him if he wants some soup. And he said yes. So she could put on the soup, put on the pot, if he go and boil. So him said him there a good while and he realized him now smell the pot. Right? And I try to figure out why in a smell, you know, you're not now cut up and in just
now you're not movement.
Right. So him lie down, him go and watch TV. And him say him gonna get up now, figure look what go on. And so I saw him ease up when he look. At the next woman yard where I come from, panty in a van. Man have an woman panty. So I saw a dirty woman come in the car and see me now.
Never expect that one there. No. No, listen to here. No, sir. I'm a dark
interest. So, a man say, he must be taking time and put on in clothes, you know, and a watch. And you say I saw him bolt out of the house. The woman just ball out. You told Tara. You what's it not lucky? Right? I burn the man, don't burn him up. Burn him up in the bed. Hey, listen man. Cass, what you learn from that? What you learn from that, Cassidy? Turn on light when I put on the clothes. What you learn from that?
Learn from what?
Yeah, from what I say a while ago. People, what want to learn from that? I want him to learn, you know? Never deal with a woman where you are at the said size. So in case I put it on, you know, either it's too big or too tight and off your own. Right? So.
Oh, when that would learn from that? Seriously? That's all you take from
that's
it?
That's all I take from it. That's all I'm going to take for any. Nothing else. So, ladies and germs, I go to the, what you call it now?
Oh.
Well, the housekeeping thing. Cassidy, the calls, them and everything, and then we go into the box park because at 10:30.
Good night, Grace.
At 10:30.
And you cast it, you know, because me that tell everybody good night. Good night to everybody. Every Portland, St. Mary, St. Thomas, all over the entire world. All who listening online, all who listening live, all who listening on them phone, the radio, anyhow you're listening. Good night, everybody.
So, what
good night, Javoy. Good night, Kadeen.
What make us? The lack of manners?
Yes, can you make people have actually tell me good night?
Oh. I mean, nothing really wrong with that. Sometimes.
That rude. What the man are doing, that woman?
The man admit already what he did that, though, so we don't need to get into that. the man admit what he did that do.
Eh? You don't feel different? You know nothing?
Me no
I
know.
Come on, take off clothes and pray out in a bed. She's like, I stop too slow. Sure, I stop. Oh. Me I put some carmel in it.
it yes, won't heat.
Man, make sure say stick like.
He's a wicked woman. Housekeeping, yeah.
The number is to call in student. The local number is 453-1444. You can call, WhatsApp, or text us on that number, 453-1444. The international number is 954-338-7973. That's 954-338-7973. And you can see there on the code numbers.
When we go off air, me tell you, oh, I just made
it. Sounds if I'm about the good numbers in the U.S., that's 213-992-4360. That's 213-992-4360. In the U.K., the number is 033-0010-3322. That's 033-0010-3322. In Canada, it's 647-957-9637. 647-957-9637. On social media, you can find Stars on YouTube, that's Stars FM Radio. On Instagram, you can follow at Stars FM. And on Twitter, it's on Stars FM 96.1. On Facebook, it's Stars FM 96.1 on the fan page. Go like them on, you go like them on Facebook. Go on YouTube, you follow them on Twitter and Instagram. Right, Kisiri?
Yep, good to go. Now, my thing is this, right?
Look here, Dwight. As some know say your sense of humor chop out from the root and then throw Gramax, Zona, acid, everything in it. Good night, Aria. Everything throw in that because you should not drop off all of your bed, you know. You don't get a joke, Dwight. At all. Good night, Denise. Me never think say at that you are gonna say. Mr. Grace, I swear, me I listen for ear is something else. Miss me never did not get a partner. Shall it look like say or something in the look here. You look like I saw him the regular cast to how he feel different tonight. The funny part, I owe him so confident. Yes, look here. Why?
For go on my muggle.
He said, go on my muggle tonight. Confident. That's what me the regular, boy. It makes me wonder because, may I say, women underwear tend to feel a little bit, they tend to be, what kind of baggy that really if he put it on and so comfortable. Go proud of it, I mean. He's too lucky. Oh my God, no. Stars FM, good night. Stars FM, good night. Hold on just a second.
Give me a second, I'm done.
All right. Hold on just a second.
Hold on. Don't hang up me down. We have fixed one little minor issue here, so. Don't hang up. We now get your true clean pan the radio, here. Yeah, hold on a little bit. Hold on. We're going to fix it right away.
No, my face hurts. Hey, that is what I said. I can't manage. Hello? Good night?
Yeah, you hear me now?
Right.
Yeah, man. Everything
loud
good.
And clear.
Yeah, Daddy. Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening, sir.
Yes, ma'am. We are doing Cleo. You don't know Cleo? You don't know Cleo?
No, man. We don't tell us that Cleo gone pan a very, very nice move, man.
Oh, okay.
That's a whole effort.
Daddy, let me show you what I'm doing, Daddy.
Hey, you know, sir, he probably would have reached because the brother would tell me, you know, he marked like me too, you know.
I your twin brother.
Hey, cool, eh? Actually, truth. When the brother tell me about say 8 or so years ago, he tell me, and every time I see,
you remember every,
and that's alone. Remember, I mean, know him. Me know him a couple of years, and that's alone. Remember, every time I see him.
Yeah, well, I still don't know that. Some of the Panty them come like brief to still enough.
Go on again. Me not hear what you say.
Some of the panty them come like a brief to still enough.
Look here, no bother with that. Because my boy shots. No. My boy shots and women have no look. Not like brief.
Go on, you're the box pop.
Look here. You see what I go on? No, dark. You don't forget dark.
What do you mean? Whenever I come to my panty, they look like rich beef. What up?
All right, man.
Hey. Oh, Taria, look here. When I go kill me, we're gonna hurt me. Hey. And the night just starts.
God
Taria
know.
Say.
We kind of want to tell you not who we know. Can't tell you no.
Me not gonna do it tonight. Taria said, well, what if him have one of the other woman party? The question to ask though is, how often does he wear other women underwear? But he make himself look guilty. Him should have take it off and say, wifey, you know, like the panty me buy for you. Good one. Foolish one. That's a good one, Terry. I'm fool. Where my run for? Sure.
Yo, listen, that did catch me off guard. Because when I tell you this story, because we're talking about something like, you know, about this whole bun business and so on and so forth. And I'm going to tell you, for him, swear what nearly happened to him through the whole bun business. So nobody ever expect that one day. But what's what Javina say?
Let's get something good because he junk him. Look here.
Nothing
in other underpants more time. No go get them checked because more time men no pay that any mind. Hey, whatever.
So
now bad I want the Javi, not even trust you, not trust it.
We'll get that already from Dwight. We read Dwight one already.
Yes, Dwight. That one was saying, Shelly, last, L-A-M-A, oh, last night off, so pops this dead in love. Okay, that's a really good one.
All right, so we're going to run go straight into the Vox Pop right now.
Hold on. Size of FM, good night.
Yeah, good night.
How are you going, road boy?
Yeah. Hey, that thing that I'm doing on my brother, not for you, 40, now.
They're not that, man.
You know thing I tell you, no?
Yeah.
Reach, man, but when you reach home, no, like, send you off the bathroom and find you, tell me before you go to the bed.
Oh, him find out?
Yes, him find out. That's what I see, but that's... And I see, you might have done the bone if I was in a free for the center, man.
Yeah.
So if no, that...
I'm not your business.
So no, that might tell him, man.
So if that happened to you, you're not sharing it with anybody?
We have to talk it out, man.
Exactly.
Yeah, your brother did have most kindness. You know, brother will reach you. But it happened to the woman in top, man. But he find out before he reached 9 bedroom. Well, maybe we'll have to.
Simple. Because I better lucky, because on a serious note, the lady is really out there a boil a pot of water for him.
Boil a pot of water for him.
Man, say, I'm taking time and put on back in clothes.
You want me to do man that door?
Straight up. Because the one I want to put Carmele in it.
Put Carmele. Close Carmele in it, man.
You see woman like you? Man, you run past you now.
Simple.
Then I run, man, yeah, like you seeing.
Man, you run past
you. Like you seeing.
You're too wicked.
Broke the record, run. You never wicked when you come home in a panty. Prowl off in a bed.
Then what wicked about that?
Yeah. Yeah.
What wicked about that?
We are doing a panty, I don't mind.
No, but at least him come home safe.
Eh? Oh, me know him safe.
Me know you know him safe.
Deadly weapon he ever carry about in a panty. Me say, she not use her head.
All right,
me
done.
Me I'm making me soup.
Yeah, man, go.
Yeah.
Me, I make the soup and can I go dash pan him, say, see it, yeah?
Anyway, we want to run in the Vox Pop right now. So, here goes. If your spouse came home without his or her wedding ring, what are some of the questions that would come to your mind? And is it something for you to be upset about? So if your spouse came home without his or her wedding ring, what are some of the questions that would come to your mind? And is it something for you to be upset about? My first thought of this one is, is having or wearing a ring a necessity? What do you think about?
Are you fair answer? I don't know. I asked you about it already.
I lost mine. Answer? Of course I answered.
I don't recall you answering. So why don't you replace it?
I've been trying to do that.
Come again.
You need to get the sample for that, right? You need to press a button to get the right sound. Right? No, I lost mine about 2 years or so ago. Right, and...
How much stuff did you buy 2 years ago?
Yeah, but there's a... I have a rational reason.
You know how... all right. Well, I don't know if you're supposed to come home without her wedding ring.
What would I do? Mm. Ask her, my girl, are you losing the ring? Where the ring there?
Oh, just them two questions then.
Yeah, but like what most people say, it depends on the response. You know, if you follow up with questions, with other questions, what were you doing? Why did you have to take it out? And the why is normally just one simple answer. It's either go sorry, not go say either. But what else you gonna do?
So I don't want none. Because I don't want to last, I don't want to forget it. No way, I don't want to take it off. So, now we're on. Vox Pop?
Yeah, Vox Pop. Before we hear people have a say. Cass, what you would I do? Moms come home, wedding ring missing. What some of the thoughts would have come to your mind?
You know what I actually answer
for? You'd ask her?
Yeah.
Ask her what?
Wearing
the. Wearing the. Oh. You know, say it last.
How is
that? Me did take it off.
Why you take it off?
Then for wash her hand, yeah.
Why you couldn't wash your hand with it
from? Because it didn't mess up, it did, made a peel banana and it's tearing up and something, I may take it off.
Why were you peeling banana?
For your dinner. Yes, you said you wanted so bananas.
Let me tell you.
Yes.
So which part? It must.
I can't find it. I looked everywhere. Maybe somebody broke in and stole it. I can't find it. I looked everywhere.
So
I was wondering if maybe I threw it out with the banana skin. Maybe I threw it out in the banana skin because I can't find it. I looked. Well, the garbage came. Chuck came and took the garbage.
So how did I deal with it? So all of those are questions and it can happen like that. It can happen like
but
that.
But how much people that believe the truth, eh?
Because no people are going to believe one different something. So
yeah,
no matter
if... Yeah, their mind are going to go somewhere right. Same time as we say, take it off. Right.
Yeah, but do you feel weird every time?
No.
It, well...
You should. Yes, you should.
Kuya, my yo, play you the box pop, yeah, man.
You see, when I ask the wrong person, you know, because I... In
should. You know, I play the bass for Pierre Medan.
Well, is it something for me to be upset about? It all depends. Because it's like a medical problem, then yes, mother be upset about that. I can't see with that. If the ring get too tight, then yeah, I can't see with that. But if I not any other reason, it better me just chop out the finger and don't send away none at all. Simple as that. Or better yet, since as him have a problem keeping it on, we can go get a permanent one. Him can tattoo it on him finger. So him not an excuse. Yeah, it's just as simple as that.
Yeah, big up on yourself, real talk, family. It all depends, you know. I mean, if you saw a certain action leading up towards that, then I have certain suspicions. After your own, you can confirm, then, yeah, it's something to worry about. But then again, I mean, them something that really happened in Jamaica. White people do them something, man. Black man, they take off ring. Do we do business if you do it? If you don't do it, we just not do it.
If your spouse came home without his or her wedding ring, what are some of the questions that would come to your mind? First of all, one, why the red ring come off? Two, if I work him go, I may know the type of job where him do, it is not required for the ring to be off. Three, I could beard him beard and leave it at the house, because me as the wife, I always make sure say him not leave the house without it. So Would I even question if I ask if I fractured that finger, get fractured, if it broke, or something was definitely wrong? Why him come home without it? Something was wrong. Are the ring too tight or something? It must be a valuable explanation for that part. So, boy, a whole heap of things that go through my mind. A whole heap of things. Yeah, I'm one of the first one that come to my mind, same way it's. I wish woman him go to him no one was say he married. So a lot of things would be going through my mind. I know that for sure.
If he's someone who is always wearing his wedding band and then all of a sudden it's not there, of course I'm going to be concerned. I want to know why he's not wearing it. Now, as long as he has a reasonable explanation, then I have no need to get upset. Because there could be several reasons why he had to take it off. So I would listen to the reason first. But if he can't explain himself, then I know I'll be getting upset. Because he'd have to tell me why he had removed it. And all sort of stuff would be going through my head. Because most men love to hide that they are married when trying to check out another girl.
No, sir. I don't know about that part. Eh? I don't know about that part, the eyed business. I don't say, you know, say, when you have on the ring, at that time you get certain level of ratings from woman. When you're up on the road and you have all your child with you as a man, at that time you get certain ratings and attention from woman. I don't know that straight up. So, when I can talk about, say, man up on a mission and they know them are eyed apart. Enough woman attracted to that. Straight up.
We so answer you. Okay, and I realize that you rather use that name, so we're gonna add you to the Sales WhatsApp group. So thank you for tuning in and
Game Atile.
Right? Yes,
Atile.
Yeah.
Forget Atile.
Now the man will come home in a but you know easy. The man will come home
in a panty.
Yeah. For real, man, have him that him forget.
Why?
It's you put the camel in it.
No, but hold on. You see if I did fear panty the man have on, right? Well, and you have a problem with that. Fine. But I no fear.
Him not fear enough for my panty either.
But I no fear.
That make it even worse when I'm doing it.
But I no fear.
The two reasons make me not go bad want him. Where am I doing underwear?
Yeah,
because
exactly.
He's a man.
Yeah.
And second reason, where am I doing in my bed in it? And if a fiend yard me that I see him approach, where am I doing that bed tonight? Right.
Then where you born at the man with water and high lamp and caramel? Listen, drop asleep.
Oh, Kadeen can't sleep, so.
Well, you don't miss much, Kadeen, except that thing that we talked about
joke.
Earlier. The joke.
Well, I dropped the shell. Yeah, the one that a prince that dropped the shell. That?
Right.
Well, and that's something there.
I mean,
that one's so like Prince.
All right. A lot of people actually are married and no ring not involved. They can't afford to buy a ring or them just decide, say, boy, it's not necessary.
Okay, ask some question. It seems that the ring is more like the woman. It's if they don't get the ring, it's like the world I got done and everything I got tumbled down if they don't get the ring. While the men might not too fussy about it. Lie, aren't you?
Because women are vain.
Men are vain too, but about cars and those kind of things. Men are vain
when
those things are concerned. But the women, them and the ring, they're obsessed.
And now for the time, the women now want to buy with the ring. And we decide, so when I buy, we want a ring.
True that. They expect you to buy the pair of ring. So you must buy for them and buy your one. I don't think so.
So.
But... it's like the ring symbolizes everything. Without the ring, there's nothing. Here, one of the Vox Pop says she's going to chop her finger. And if it lasts, she's going to make sure tattoo it on Panda like the man can take off the tattoo. Oh, Kadeen is saying that the ring makes female feel a sense of security. Really, no?
And when a man wear the ring, it make you feel like, say, it make a woman feel like they own you. That's why women so sentimental if a man lasts a ring. Almost that.
But as you're saying, the ring makes you more attractive to females. Because they must say, yeah, when I have no responsibility, that's the first thing I come.
you know, last week.
And they can blackmail you.
I was in bank last week, and the lady, the teller, she's married, and we have a conversation. I'm tell her, I say, I'm married and thing, and she take me on the same time about when I ring there. I'm tell her, how the ring last. You go and see the woman get cross for me. Probably if I never work, I'm going to get a fine cussing. I said, John Osteen, if me disamit is a woman, I suppose I shared with my wife.
You never go by one at the ring there long time.
No, me wonder if I survived the night. I said, John Osteen, she behaves, she just know me. Why, me never know. Anyway, it's now 10 o'clock, ladies and gentlemen. We're going for a break. And we're so far. The time is brought to you by VJ Printed Services.
Bring back the time.
So forward.
Architects, draftsmen, and surveyors, get your drawings printed in high-quality professional standards. We can satisfy your printing needs. Whether it is for presentation to your clients or for submitting building and subdivision application, make it VJ Printing Services. Whether drawing by hand or with computer-aided softwares, we will plot your negatives and print the copies as you need. We do high-quality white paper printing that is water-resistant and never fades, unlike traditional blueprint. For more information, call VJ Printing at 893-2266.
Yo, my dad. A whole heap of money I man spend on that event here, you know. So me have to make sure it promote proper.
Yo, nothing. Link Styles FM bought them summer bonus package.
Summer bonus package. I want that.
5 grand, 1 week party promo shillings. 10 grand, 2 week party promo shillings. Mr. Ads, mentions, interview, giveaway, straight styling. 2869216 or 4395160. Link them now.
No, no.
Styles FM summer bonus package. Conditions apply.
Hey, what's up, Bob? BNW Promotion presents Smirnoff Beach Fantasy, Yellow and White Edition. Place to be, Almond Lodge, Orange Bay, Portland, Sunday, July 31st. Thank the Lord, we're not the worst. Music by DJ Rush, DJ Flair, Les 5000, Rockaway Movement. Live performance by Chiching Ching, the Breadfruit Man. Special guest appearance by Acid, hosted by Miss Kitty, the Fluffy Diva. Swimwear contest, wet t-shirt contest, raffle prizes and giveaways. Smirnoff Beach Fantasy, Yellow and White Affair is at 12 to 12 events, so early is the time that you're gonna get there. Admission 1,000 pre-sold, 1,200 at the gate, 1,500 after 7 p.m., 3,000 VIP. Smirnoff Beach Fantasy, July 31st. Get there!
That one ya bono.
Better know say Saturday the 30th of July. But Whiskey and Tampi from Road Marshal. In association, it takes like a gas station, Buffet proudly presents the 13th annual Portland Summer Splash. And no say at Force Beach Club. Warfleet Orange Bay, the place to be the 30th of July. And don't know say music by the World Sound Jamrock. DJ Stone I go did it. DJ Andy from New York and DJ Randy from Calchester. Treat for the kids all day. Food and refreshments. Step on sale. Admission a free before 1 a.m. Be a little thing after. But Winky and Tampi that wanna slap way. I don't know the twins of pass through. Curly locks and two locks. I sick a sitting. 30th of July. You know say I want Saturday that. 13th annual Portland Summer Splash. It's not to be missed.
Sick.
Hey, it's not a dream anymore. Hallelujah, anyhow. The third edition, Styles FM presents Hallelujah, anyhow. In Portland, Portland Town, yo. Portland Tony High School Ground comes alive July the 30th. You got to be there. Featuring Lieutenant Stitchy.
I will do the number. I will do the number. I'm a brand new person, brand new life. And I will do the no more. Some things I used to.
Hey, the great George Knox.
Thank you, Lord.
Keisha Bear.
You never not get in store in that hand. Him try great.
Sister Bat.
Rock my soul in
and of course, Minister Mark Ricketts from out of Canada will be there. Yes, alongside Lamar Ari. And you know, our singing sensation on Styles FM every Sunday, Michaela Benjamin. And of course, yours truly, Heavy D, will be there from the Styles FM crew. Admission, 1,000 pre-sold, 1,200 at the gate. Children under 12, 500 at the gate. Hosted by Reverend Lewis, Pastor Lindsay, and Sister Victoria. Gates open at 5 p.m. Showtime, 7 p.m. sharp. You can't miss it. Hallelujah, anyhow. Adopt me, I say, one more time. Hallelujah, anyhow. Hallelujah, anyhow.
Tickets for Hallelujah Anyhow are available at these locations: Rightway Pharmacy Royal Mall, Bombrook Ice Cream Shop, Supercare Pharmacy Bridge Street, YK's Pharmacy Upstairs Singer, Shoppers Sprite Supermarket Buff Bay, Miss Mac One Stop Mini Mart Bombrook, K&D Variety Hector's River, Seaview Discount Center 14 Harbor Street, and VNC International Travel Consultants 17 Harbor Street, Juta Building. Remember, tickets are only $1,000 pre-sold, so get them now.
Get them now, ladies and gentlemen. Hallelujah. Anyhow, it's a very, very, very entertaining event. Yeah, man. I'm encouraging you to be at Hallelujah Anyhow to come and get some blessing. I'm going to be there getting a lot of blessing. One of the things, some things happen behind the scene. The calendar. When we had the photo shoot, you remember Cassidy, when we were there in our Oak Bay Valley, our Victoria and Heavy D and Pastor Lindsay and Reverend Lewis then try baptize me, then try dip me. you have it? Hey, no, sir. No, we don't have a post.
And then I succeed, though.
Bro, same way. Every day, Reverend Lewis tonight. Right? So, bro, burn up. Right? Yeah.
So, I'm getting married soon, Nadu, right?
Mm-hmm.
But my husband to be don't want me to wear any ring. And him don't want to wear any ring. It's me alone must wear the ring.
Yeah.
Do you think it is fair?
Nothing wrong with that. There's no fear.
Read the question again.
It's 566. I'm getting married soon to my guy. No, I'm getting married soon, and my guy don't want any. And my guy don't want any ring. Me alone must wear the ring.
Is that fair?
Nothing wrong with that.
It can't be fear.
Is that a fear issue?
It can't be fear.
Is that a fear issue?
Of course, it's a fear issue.
Which bus are they upon?
Which bus?
We never talk.
We don't chat. Nobody call camera run, like foolishness.
Hold on. Let me hear this. Yeah. Good night.
Charm.
Good night.
Good night, Charm. Come go Charm for no work when she don't work.
No, the phone, the internet a problem from what here, Charm. The internet a problem from what here.
WhatsApp every day. WhatsApp come back this morning and the phone all requirements. Nobody not in my mind. And I come back and me think so in the come back.
No, that is Styles come start it out not too long.
Okay. What you mean, both are nothing wrong with where you're now wearing no ring? What you mean? Why? So what you making now wearing no ring?
What a Charm, why we have to wear a ring? Tell me why we have to wear a ring.
Ring too.
No, but you're up on your own.
What?
Wait, you're up on your own.
Oh, me up on my own. Okay.
Yeah.
Really? Well, me they make sure you buy my ring and me buy it for you. But me want to make sure so you're in that. As for me see.
Then hold on. What kind of bad up something that? Me not, then suppose me not feel, say, as a man, me not want to wear a ring. You don't want me.
What do you mean? Someone making
a woman, you know? I remember asking that question, Charm. You want me? We're married. You want me? And why am I to explain to you why I'm not wearing a ring?
Answer fast, Charm. Answer fast.
Me not want you.
You want him?
Own what?
You sign receipt, fee, my contract. What you talk about?
Own who?
Listen, me not want you, but you're licensed to me for the time where we're married, okay?
Charm, I really say a while ago.
Me no know what you matter about that ownership.
Me too.
What kind of license that?
Contract.
What?
You? Eh. The time when we married, you license to me.
Yeah, but Charm, we license for better and for worse and for all kind of other sitting. But this, for wear the ring, what kind of ownership that? That means if you tell me, say, boy, me for wear the ring, me for wear the ring. If you say, me not for wear the ring, me not for wear the ring. A kind of boy business that. That's why the man going with have a new man panty, you know, because the man, the regime mash up in meds. But Charm, me no need for wearing a ring.
Why you want to wear your ring? What's the point?
But Charm, the man has said in the thing, the lady has
said. We exchange from me, you buy me my ring, I'm here buy you your ring. You're supposed to wear your ring. Why? And I want to wear your ring.
But he doesn't want to be bought a ring.
Hide and seek. Is he doing that then?
Charm, no bother wasting money, man. Buy some pampers or sitting for you pick the way I come.
No. Not that case, no pitney now go come, because I'm married himself.
And we are talking thank about Shells.
Thank you, please.
Hey, my brethren, give me a talk last week, and true, me never see the WhatsApp, you know. That's why the road wife, they run the thing. No more side chick, no more. No. The man say a road wife, then name here, sir.
Be a style inside the woman, then me no butt.
Later, Charm.
All right.
Yeah.
Kayan is from Chepstow. From where Chepstow, Kayan, I listen from it. You know. Erica pumps big up for the sale. Erica, she's saying, say, Pops come home without him ring already. I'm a behave bad. Only to find out it come off in the gas aisle bucket at work. Still never believed, though. So you see how it go?
Simple.
The man was telling the truth, I kill him. Can you imagine?
Simple.
No, man. Hello, good night.
Good night. Good night.
Hello.
Where's the road boy?
You're strange. Very strange question.
Yeah.
What you wear, is it a choice? Do you have a choice?
Thank you very much.
My car.
Thank you very much.
Excuse me, Dan.
Hello. As an adult, when you leave the house with whatever you want to be attired in, or whatever adornment you want to have, is it a choice you have, or someone, it's a collaboration between wife and husband?
I saw no just chat nothing, you know. I saw no just chat enough. Because you see the things that you want.
I'm trying to learn something. Just give me an answer.
You're asking a question?
Yes, give me an answer.
Oh, it sounded like a statement to me. As an adult, you're entitled to do certain things, yes. But when you partner up with somebody else, you're no longer entitled fully like that. The other person's opinion matters.
I get it.
The other person's opinion matters. And if your wife put on one ride away, I'll cheat them, I drop through it, and you look on her. Just missing one of the memes, something them online where the woman have on one miniskirt, and those man, I said to her, I said, hello, you feel weird that go to the road, but you'd have to put a bra on. It was a joke kind of thing, but that's how it goes. The men would love to dictate what you don't do, but they want to do whatever them please. And I say, go.
What is the purpose of marriage?
I don't know.
Or any relationship for that matter.
Companionship and a lot of other things.
Companionship, yeah. And dictatorship, what else?
Dictatorship?
Yeah, companionship.
And I said a lot of other things. Companionship. Yeah, companionship covers under a wide umbrella, if you ask me.
Listen, my thing is I'm knowing. If women feel say they're not gonna marry somebody and try it, but a man, an adult man, all right, who it's culturally and historically where I'm deciding one destiny. If a woman ever, if a woman, I don't marry with that mindset. It's
gonna be a culture. It's gonna be
foolishness.
Dan. It's gonna be a culture shock.
Foolishness.
I'm finding the right word.
Must, all right, uno married without ring then. If that is the case, the marriage is to take place with no ring. So the wife no wear no ring and the husband no fi wear no ring. And that's the end of that.
No, you have to wear a ring.
No. No. Him can't tell me if we're wearing and him don't want to wear none.
And the wife decide to wear a ring.
The match, the add up. Because in marriage, every time I see people are married, I see rings. It is a symbol. It is a strong symbol of the marriage.
Yes. Okay.
So why him decide to him don't want to wear none?
But who decide that symbol? It's an individual choice, isn't it?
Which individual choice? Dan, how it become an individual choice if it's going to be a marriage?
Hold on.
What does the ring indicate?
Society cannot tell you that you have to wear a ring because you're married. No rule of society.
No. But that's what society has been dictating for years. Everybody run go buy the white dress and the tuxedo and the two ring them. That's what society has been dictating all these years. That everybody follow it.
Okay, so you're saying... If men get married and you don't wear a ring, you violate the standard for the marriage.
No. You're not understanding what I'm saying. Because we're saying society dictates. But they said the ring symbolizes the unity of the marriage. And that's representation. That's a physical representation. That's what I'm saying. So if it is a symbol and the dictation is that both of us is supposed to have a ring to notify everybody, say, look here, Shelly and Dandan married now. Why is it that Danana is going to choose that he doesn't want one? Me not going to wear one then?
Because again, Shelly, and as an adult, I don't have his own individual choice to make.
Well, as an adult, I have my individual choice to wear. I mean, now we are none.
Dan. Oh, wait, cut off. Dan. I'm not here. I hear what going on. We're going to run the next Vox Pop. God, I wonder. Hey, lady, is it an odd question that we're going to come up with a hat of Shelly head? Run the next Vox Pop for me to cast though.
I mean, I think Mona upset at first, but the first question Mona asked is, what happened to it? And then depending on the response, then Mona knows if something to get upset about.
So if I can get a direct reason, a good reason why it is not home, I won't get upset. But if I can get to the bottom of it, well, there it goes.
Let's see. I think, you know, there can be so many different reasons why you're supposed to come out without it or her wedding ring. It could be that they lost it, they misplaced it, or it could be that them... You know, I live a double life in which them have it out there, so them not married, so them not wear them ring, and then come home without their ring. And it could be just an innocent, I forgot my wedding ring. Who sometimes not forget their wedding ring, right? Or who sometimes maybe go to work, maybe depending if I'm a mechanic or whatever, I wash their hand or do some mechanic work, no want the ring mess up, take it off and leave it same place, man. You know, they washed up and don't remember and come home without it. It could be so many different reasons. I think the first thing to do is ask, what happened to the wedding ring before, you know, we get upset about it. But if it's just that the person careless, no one wear their wedding ring now, then we have a problem with that, because I think it's being, in a sense, not respecting the vows that we make, because that's a part of our vows. But who say a wedding ring I won't make a marriage? A wedding ring is not what make a marriage. So at the end of the day, me personally, me not say me wanna be upset. It depends on the story. What me wanna know first is why you come without your wedding ring, and then me take it from there. Real talk.
If my spouse came home without his ring, honestly, me wanna get upset about it, because me no wear mine half the time. So, actually, me no wear mine most of the time. So me can't get upset about it. Me know for a fact that me land in Jamaica whole heap of time and no ring. everybody a question, what happened to your ring? At home, jewelry box. I just say stay sometime. So I wouldn't get upset about it. If in come with a fierce response, no, then me would have probably fire back something. But, you know, I just saw it go.
I text you,
lick
my brain
shot. Did
you see that text?
Oh, that one,
what is
that?
No, one text by
line.
No, lick me like, I'm like.
All right, I'm going to say what 5558 I say.
Not the roots. It's more than 10 years now. I can't find my ring. And up, hey, that's my daddy. Not change your name, you know. And up until now, my wife doesn't ask me for it. I notice that she's not wearing her own, and I do not ask her why she's not
no,
wearing
it. No, I have a problem with that one
there. Excuse you?
No, I have a problem with that one there. Remember, you know, there are two things. All right, me lost my ring. You think Karen can go and tell me, say, she now wear a ring?
She last fair too?
No, I know last fair won't last.
No, but he can't ask her what
no,
to
no, man, listen to what I'm saying. No, that's not what he said.
No, but he's not. He don't know what happened to it. He never asked her.
No, he said she's not wearing
right,
it.
Right, and he did not ask her why she's not no, wearing it.
Yeah, him say, you see, if it did last or missing, me sure said the writer would have write and say,
no,
her
him
last.
Not know because him not ask. She's just not wearing it.
She's just
and
not
because
wearing
it. Him last him under suspicious circumstances.
No. You're not suspicious with that.
No,
none whatsoever, not suspicious. Yeah.
Well, I think happened to me last week, Tuesday.
Yeah.
My boyfriend live with me, but he's from Boston. He told
Massachusetts.
Just Sebastian.
Okay.
He told me that he had some family members come. No, a Jamaica, I look like family member coming in from abroad. So he had to go by the house to clean up and get someone to cut the yard. And just man work, so my help won't be needed. He came down back with a panty into a bath rag, bearding rag, asking me if it's mine. Like, seriously? Because me vexed with him last night. He might tell me about me not cheat.
No, but she need to get a comfy dress. That me I talk about.
Eh? She no got the house?
Nah, man. She need to get a comfy.
Oh, she forgive her comfy and him alone go there and come back with him. Brave
No. Him go there go find that.
Yeah, no, me not think. I don't know.
I don't know.
Me not think. Me think that somebody else I use the place. It's one of the, you know, one of the house there where they use.
I don't want to go that road, man. Why you want to put me talk? I don't want to go that road, man. I don't want to go that road, man. I said, I don't want to go that road.
Different is still Texas.
I want to stick to the road of me. I go.
I don't think you would have so brave. If you care when somebody else underwear in a rag come ask if I feel.
No, you know, and you're correct. Because you know I reach me one at a time. I'm going to say to moms now, I'm going to say, look at mom's face, right? Me say, the what is it name? We tear off a sanitary napkin. The paper there. I go one day and I go see it in my driveway. And I take up my phone innocently, you know, and call moms and say, moms, yo, you know, say, I just say, well, you know, not sanitary napkin, the word me use. I don't know if I'm out. Right? And moms want to take me on, you know. I blow in front of a road, you know, dogs scatter things all over the place. That is my assumption.
You couldn't shut your mouth.
And that I should have done. And that bridge I should have done. Road boy, certain things, you know, do.
Yeah, man, left it. Dash it away, man. No,
certain
clean,
things
clean,
you
not
do.
Oh, somebody said good thing about Sabbath keeper. They don't wear ring. Are you?
We never know that one there. You sure?
Hi, Styles. Can you ask the audience if you saw your significant other out on a date and is her ring wasn't on their finger? How would you react?
No, that one there a problem. That one there a problem. Straight up. That one there a big problem.
You know, if you ask a question if the person is out
yeah,
and
that one there a big problem. That one there a big problem. Big problem. Big problem. That means that a person that in my view no never make the thing straight and the person where them are par with, maybe they don't want them feel uncomfortable. Because sometimes you can go up on some little social whatever thing, you know, and the person feel, you know, I mean, I like to look the way I give my shells. But I'm not saying it's right, you know. I'm not saying it's right, it's wrong. But maybe that are the reason. But if the person are going to feel uncomfortable with you being in the situation where
that's
you're
not, them
exactly,
excuse you.
It don't make no sense.
No.
You know, right, you can't value that the kind of
but
link.
But if you see person out on a date, whether or not them wearing a ring, that's just it. Like, no matter if them are wearing a ring, if they're out on a date, that's bad. Look here, Kadeen, me no need nothing, you hear? Whatever you think that I'm needing, no, I don't.
So, I want to run through one next Vox Pop. We kind of race it off because I'm telling you, say, last week, you cussed me off and said, I should make the lady come on earlier. So, at least we're going to hold a reason with her earlier this time. So, maybe we can have a half hour and 15 minutes for all her talk.
Because last week we got 10 minutes over the time.
Yeah.
Vox Pop.
All right, pertaining to that question, coming home without the wedding ring would obviously pose a question to me. Who have you been with, right, that is causing you to be hiding your marital status? And why is it that you have to actually take off the ring, right? So who you're with and why you have to take off the ring, right? Two decent questions, so it would, you know, be the main questions in my mind. I wouldn't even care about who the person is at the time. I just want to know, why is it that you have to take off the ring, you know? That is the main question. Why? And why you have to hide your marital status?
All right. On an adult and mature level, seeing your spouse home without his or her wedding band, it is nothing for you to jump and get upset about. However, some questions naturally will come to your mind, like, why is it not on? And that's number one. And then you'll be wondering if he probably had gone someplace where he wouldn't want whosoever to know that he's married. That's one, if that is one of the reasons why it's missing. And naturally you're going to be wondering if he took it off because he's hiding that he is engaged or more so married to somebody. But to just jump and get upset, I don't think that's very mature like. But naturally, as I keep saying, you will have a ton of questions flooding your mind.
So if I can get a direct reason, a good reason why it is not home, I won't get upset. But if I can get to the bottom of it, well, there it goes.
The first question that would come to my mind would be, where is your ring? And then, depending on his answer, other questions would come, where are you coming from and stuff like that. But I wouldn't get alarmed in the first instance. I would find out first. The first question that would come to my mind would be, where is your ring? And then, depending on his answer, other questions would come, where are you coming from and stuff like that. But I wouldn't get alarmed in the first instance. I would find out first.
Actually, first, I wouldn't just get upset like that. I would question the reason or ask why, you know, the person doesn't have the wedding ring. I'll explain that I noticed that there's not the wedding ring is not on the finger. And then from there, I'll know. What if it is something that has been happening more than once? That's a different thing. A lot of questions will come to my mind as to whether or not the person, you know, has any problem or issues. Why are the person is hiding from someone or something like that?
Mic check, yeah.
You checking mic? Wow.
M-I-C. You can see the go and talk.
You said it.
So we have one more Vox Pop to play. We might have cut it short because we're going to, at 10:30, after that break, we're going to make that contact to our caller from last week. She's currently in a toxic relationship. She's married, and it was a really touching conversation last week, and we want to continue with it this week. So we're going to go straight into the other Vox Pop, close out on that, and then we go into the real talk for the night.
Yeah, it affects more that. I mean, that's why she'd have to take off the ring while she go out. Like, is that different if she don't want no, she don't want the ring like go down with Jenna or something? Yeah.
It depends on if your partner is somebody you know and you've been together for a while and you've built up a certain level of trust. So if they come home without a wedding ring, it may not mean anything.
Well, given that there are circumstances beyond control at times that cause certain things to happen and would seemingly appear to be of one aspect, we of mature mind now have to be concerned, not really upset. And from being concerned now, we acquire what was the reason of this dismissal of the ring. You know what I mean? And we investigate from there. With a mindset that, okay, we have an open mind, anything could have happened, you know what I mean? Because things do happen, you see what I say? But at the same time, we're not going naive like we don't know, say, cheating can involve and rare. So we have the two mindset in our head back and I go and pray the thing. until we come to the conclusion of what really took place, why the ring was missing in the first place. You understand? And then from this, you know, we duck parts and pop off limb off of people. If the people am guilty. You understand? Yeah.
Well, if he come home without the ring on his finger, it seemed to me that he was hiding his marriage from somebody. He might just meet her, or he might be in some kind of thing with her, so you know, want her for no one. Why would a man take off his ring off his finger? To show everybody that you're married. So why you don't want to take it off? I must trick you, trick somebody. You can't think of nothing else. It too tight? No, sir. I burn him again, me. And maybe I would be upset. It all depends on the mood. If I would argue with him about it. Or maybe just question him about it next time. Because sometimes he get too much heat at the time. So it just flare up into something he don't really want. But I burn him again, me. Yeah.
Like I say, it has to do with, you know, the relationship you guys have. And over time, you develop what we call trust. Your ring can come off for several reasons. It could be on the road and you go, put me wash something and it's loose on your finger. And you don't want to say the wash. And then probably say, I wash the car and it come off and it lasts. Probably you take it off and put it in your pocket. Sometimes you take it off and forget to put it in your pocket. So, it you know, I wouldn't see that. Like I say, it depends on the individual, though. You should know your partner over time, and over time you should know what they're capable of. Even though some people can hide very well, you know. But I think if you're in a relationship with somebody, you can't trust them implicitly, you should just get out of the relationship. You shouldn't have to be worrying about what it is they're doing or not doing.
Truth is that if I saw my husband come out with his ring off, trust me, my blinker, I stay and my blinker would be up. So I know, me know me stay, me ask him why I'm ring off. But if him have a good explanation, me all right with it. But if him can't explain why his ring is off, then a problem. And I know also, if him tell me something, me know me stay, you know me, that's in my back of my brain, and me don't want to know exactly what is what. Okay. Although I know a man can have a side chick and side chick know totally about me, but it still suggests that if he's not running ring and he have a side chick, she don't know nothing about me. And
yep, she don't know nothing about you. Anyway, it's now 10:31, ladies and gentlemen. We'll go to a break. And we're soon forward. The time is brought to you by VJ Printing Services.
Architects, draftsmen, and surveyors, get your drawings printed in high-quality professional standards. We can satisfy your printing needs. Whether it is for presentation to your clients or for submitting building and subdivision application, make it VJ Printing Services. Whether drawing by hand or with computer-aided softwares, we will plot your negatives and print the copies as you need. We do high-quality white paper printing that is water-resistant and never fades, unlike traditional blueprint. For more information, call VJ Printing at 893-2266.
Summer time for the ladies, summer time for the girl them, summer time, yeah, yeah.
Me and my car full of girls, where we gonna reach? Sunshine Beach! Lavish Family presents Coolest Fete Anniversary on Friday, August 5th at Sunshine Beach. Hosted by Youngster Family. Music by DJ Flair, Little Richie, and Gemini. Admission $800, pre-sold $1,000 at the gate.
It's no joke like Riddle.
Yo, my dad. A whole heap of money I man spent on that event here, you know. So me have to make sure it promote proper.
Yo, nothing. Link Styles FM bought them summer burn-up package.
Summer burn-up package? I want that.
$5,000, 1 week party promo shellings. $10,000, 2 week party promo shellings. Me say ads, mentions, interview, giveaway, straight styling. 286-9216 or 439-5160. Link them now. No. Styles FM summer burn-up package. Conditions apply.
This feeling is taking over me. I'm so excited.
Feeling you
euphoria.
Tuesdays from 5 to 9 p.m. with the master mixer musical maestro Digital C.
Giving a total satisfaction with melodies and memories by the score. With the widest selection of genres and hits. So you don't know the program, you turn up, you know. So you know politics are full dust, the one that one you slap with.
Digital and we are party, yeah we flawless. Euphoria the program, every Tuesday.
5 to 9, every Tuesday.
With the musical maestro Digital C.
It's not a dream, it's not a dream anymore. Hallelujah, anyhow. The third edition. Styles FM presents Hallelujah, anyhow. In Portland, Portland Town, yo. Portland Tony High School Ground comes alive July the 30th. You got to be there. Featuring Lieutenant Stitchy.
I will do the number. I'm a brand new person, brand new life. And I will do the no more. Some things I used to.
Hey, the great George Knox.
Thank you, Lord.
Keisha Pear.
You never not get in the store. In that hand.
Not get in the store.
Him try to create.
Sister Bat.
Rock my soul.
And of course, Minister Mark Ricketts from out of Canada will be there. Yes, alongside Lamar Ari. And you know, our singing sensation on Styles FM every Sunday, Michaela Benjamin. And of course, yours truly, Heavy D, will be there from the Styles FM crew. Admission, 1,000 pre-sold, 1,200 at the gate. Children under 12, 500 at the gate. Host by Reverend Lewis, Pastor Lindsay, and Sister Victoria. Gates open at 5 p.m. Showtime, 7 p.m. sharp. You can't miss it. Hallelujah, anyhow. Adopt me, I said. One more time. Hallelujah, anyhow. Hallelujah, anyhow.
Tickets for Hallelujah Anyhow are available at these locations. Rightway Pharmacy Royal Mall, Bombrook Ice Cream Shop, Supercare Pharmacy Bridge Street, YK's Pharmacy Upstairs Singer, Shoppers Pride Supermarket Buff Bay, Miss Mac One Stop Mini Mart Bombrook, K&D Variety Hectors River, Seaview Discount Center 14 Harbor Street, and VNC International Travel Consultants 17 Harbor Street, Juta Building. Remember, tickets are only $1,000 pre-sold, so get them now.
Yep, only 1,000 pre-sold. Get them now. So we're going to read the WhatsApp messages, and then after that we'll close out the Vox Pop and then we make our connection. Grace, what you saying, Grace?
Okay, so Grace is saying that rule, same rule for both.
No.
Yeah, it make it look like, say, woman for glad for broadcast. Them taken, but uno man no one nobody for know, say, uno taken.
No, that's far from the truth. Far from the truth.
I won't even look into
it. You know, and we don't need to have a debate. Women just must always just represent what's right.
Good night.
And a follow away and represent what's wrong.
Good night. The one that don't want to wear his or her ring as something to hide.
No, Miss B.
See that one already. Cassidy, go up to Dwight and Jaffeen. Good night. Yeah, we see that. Dwight is saying that the rude when me no wear my ring, but my wife claims her ring lost. Oh, him say wear frame ring.
Well, then it lasts.
Well, if her ring lasts, it lasts.
It lasts. You just need to buy her a new one. As long as she have a, if she start making excuse, then you have a problem.
Oh, Sabbath keeper, what now? Oh, Sabbath keeper, what now? Lady Bill. Do 10 weddings, Sabbath weddings, one just yesterday, and rings turn up. Oh, behavior.
Yeah.
That brother, they don't know about, both broke and pop off. My thing is, we put too much focus on things that most time just cause the other to just run some bun. Accuse me, okay, bun. How what day I'm bun? I know Easter done, gone, and whatever. What wrong with you, Javin? I'm bun.
So, ladies and gentlemen, the order is in your court as to whether or not you are wearing. And if your person with you now where if them have a problem with it, see how best you can replace the ring. My situation is that, say, mom, say, boy, when me I buy back my one, me need to buy one for the same time, and me disagree with her. So that's how we stand off there. So me don't plan to buy my one, and she have to just work out herself with the one where she got. So not because my one new means a fair one for go new too. Me not depend on one there. So
bad mind turn up a scream, load.
Point fear don't. She bad mind don't. Okay, not look that to give me. She have it on already.
You know, take it from her and go melt it and buy a new one, girl, and a new one she want it on off a step out Chris. You know, you do renew the vow and get a new pair of ring. But take the old one from her and melt it down.
We agree with the meltdown part. Mm. That part we agree with, but the other part, there's no necessity for that.
For renew your vows?
Yeah, money you spend where unnecessary.
No, you don't have to spend the money, what do you?
But it's not necessary.
You don't have the minister, yeah?
It's not necessary. The vow in a hole. Anyway.
Good night.
Cousin, good night, Steve.
Yeah.
I want to go ahead and put up an argument I'm going from Shelly.
What are you talking about?
Not talking about. This is what I'm talking about.
Huh? What kind of yo?
You get born and get out of attack. So now get the time to go pop after him.
Oh, I see where you've been.
The ring business is important, you know?
Yeah.
Because a woman can't give the knocking to the ring for a wedding single game, you know?
Real talk.
It don't matter to people nowadays.
And a man can't do it. Nobody now forgot to take out him something again. A Jamaica live and some white people.
To be honest, I don't think it matters. No matter which country you're in, I really don't think it matters to people anymore whether or not you have a piece of wire on your finger.
It doesn't really matter, Shelly. Because anyway, right now, you meet her with a married woman and she wants to give her a girl.
Exactly.
And she take it off.
All right.
So, it's really not really important. If I see a woman in a restaurant that eats her next to the nigga, you know, she left out to the ring and she's not having time and everything. Just walk straight, cause mash everything mash up the center.
All right, why are you listening? All right, thanks. So while you're listening to the rest of the program, right? Because it's going to be really, really hot, right?
Yeah, respect me, Dan. Cool, huh? Yeah, man. So to each his own, it's an important part of the thing, but this whole issue where people would want to make out. No, say so you're after this and you're after that, and if you don't do this and you can't, that and answer that and call fat. No, me can't manage that part there. You know, them the type of demands and like a bad up business. Me know me turn already, now go work out with me. Straight up. Now go work out. So, want to make a link there right now with the young miss from last week and, you know, continue our conversation. It was very, very, very in depth last week. And want to say, what grounds we can cover this week, and a lot of our listeners were very, 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 you know, encouraging to her, but they wanted more. They realized they made kind of a race. It's still due to the time, and we have on our phone line the missus from last week. Good night. How are you?
Good night. I'm okay.
Great, 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 great. I just want to tell you, on behalf of our listeners, that we are very grateful of you granting us this opportunity again this week. And last week was very informative. And by popular demand, I reached out to you, and I'm really glad that you accepted to be back here tonight. So how have things been?
Okay, there's some little hiccups now and there, but everything is going well.
Everything is going well?
Yeah.
Well, in terms of you and him?
No, you know, well, no, that side is not. It's not how you want it to be, and I guess it's in relation to the human side of persons at times. You know, persons have different personalities, different ways in dealing with breakups and heartache, so... You know, it's not an easy. I would have expected it to be Okay. Kind of somewhat rocky, but I never expected it to be this hard. But I'm coping.
Okay. And so for my listeners, let me give them a rundown of what we had discussed last week. This young miss, pretty young, intelligent. She has been through a rough relationship, especially even with the recent death of her mother. About a year now, your mother has passed, right?
Yes.
And she's also a mother. And employed, attractive, but there's just this issue right now that we're gonna ask her for how long this has been happening, but in terms of her being married with her husband and then things just it wasn't hunky dory from morning, but it seemed to have gotten worse now that they're married, and she has taken the decision to actually move out of the matrimonial home. And when we say move out, we mean real move out of the matrimonial home, for which she's still paying a mortgage, and she's paying rent, but he's the one that's living in the house. Now, my girl, may I tell you something, I rate for that one, because would man, if I was sitting for you to reach me, that the privilege to reach me, would man cock up in the house, me one, you know, may I tell you, choke. I'm for galang, just galang, you know. It just feel like a dream life for y'all, man, you know, may I tell you. Because all we hear, I said, the woman gone with half of what we have, everything, and the next man moving at the house. So right now,
every day, me, I go sprinkle sugar around at the house, there. You want to live in it, please. I just want to kill it.
So, you know, I'm just being cynical. Well, let me ask you though, how you do it? Like, because you said you've moved out before, right?
Yes.
And you went back. Did you go back in pity? Is he a good, what I call it now, in make him kiss? All right. Firstly, what was the reason you moved out the first time or this or so?
You know, actually, the first time I moved out was long before we got married, before kids were even thought of coming into the picture.
Okay.
I moved out because he said to me one evening, we're there, and, you know, just having a second, and then he just said to me, I'm trying to love you and I can't.
Wow.
And I mean, that hit something deep within. And then I just said, you know what, I just started to pack.
Wow. So
yeah, I just started to pack, and I just decided that, you know what, you can't love me, no problems, I'm going to go.
And what made you go back?
Feeling sorry for him, one really wanted the relationship to work, because here I was with this person for almost, 5 years.
Okay.
Yes, and so you really 5 years in a relationship is not an easy thing to give up, and you know, persons do say things mess up. I mean, there came the apology saying that he was sorry, and you know, he was going through a rough time, you know, and he never meant what he said. But then at the same time, you know, you just, all right, then, you know, let's just try. Since he apologizes, let us try. He was there crying and all the tears, and I'm that type of person that tears really gets to me.
Boy, it catch me all the time too, you know. Back in the days, boy, I tell you the amount of heart my broke, I should have left. But from the start ball. So you know what I start to now? I start do things for them left me. It work out better that way there.
Yeah.
So let me ask you. The kids came into being. Was when you got pregnant, was he happy? Did he want kids, or did it just happen? Was it planned?
No, you know, surprisingly, he wanted kids. It's something that we were trying for almost 2 years.
Yeah?
Yes. So we were trying for almost 2 years.
And yeah, black him. I'm a fire blank.
No, you know, it wasn't blocking. I guess, you know, when I look back at it, it could be a case where I should not have been, and so it was taking for a time and to see certain signs, but then you block those signs. And then another point of it, you know, when the doctor was saying, boy, you're stressed, or when you're under stress, or when persons, majority of the time when persons are planning a pregnancy, it's more harder than when you're not, it just happened like that.
Okay. So you were stressed?
Yeah, well, you know, the type of field that I was in, and the job, it, you know, stress related.
Okay,
you know,
okay.
They normally say, well, doctors at times say that, you know, when you're under stress, it's more harder for the female to get pregnant. So those type of things.
Okay, okay. So, and I spoil him, I'll spoil.
Well, you know, really, I can't say. Because, you know, most men, you know, on a whole don't like to go and do a test.
Yeah.
So if the count is lower or not. And so from that side for me, I can't say. So I don't know if it was and it was built or it was normal and it was just really the stress or it just wasn't time.
Well, I guess it just wasn't time. All right. So when the kids came now, the kids finally came or during pregnancy. Let's take it in stages now. We have a little bit of time. During pregnancy, what kind of person was he to you?
It was kind of mixed.
Okay.
At first, finding out that I was pregnant, happiness was there and everything. But then, you know, for someone that always wanted children, you'd have expected a better reaction during those 9 months. Because I remember once I started to swell very early.
Mm-hmm.
In my pregnancy. And then I remember when I was supposed to get out of heels, now my doctor said, you need to get out of the heels. You know, you ask, can you purchase me a pair of flat shoes, please? And surprisingly, the response was, you don't just get paid. And I'm like, oh my God, is this the person that wants children? Does it matter if I just get paid or not? Right? It doesn't even matter, yes, that. You wanted kids now, or I could have waited. The whole point is that here is your other half saying to you, listen to me. I need to get out of the heels. My feet are swollen. Doctor say, yes, it's time for me to get flat, and I'm asking you to buy me a pair of flats. And you're asking me about my salary.
Wow. So let me ask you a question. You did just get paid for sure?
That's neither here nor there. Like,
you know,
like, how money came into that equation?
I'm just. We can't laugh this week, you know.
No, surprisingly, you know. You know, it was like maybe like a week and a half after payday.
Okay, okay. No, a week and a half, a long time. A long time that. So, all right. So, did he buy it?
No, I bought it myself.
Wow.
No, because I'm the type of person.
So he actually said it pretty much that you need to get it yourself and you end up even having to do it irrespective of you being the carrier of his kids.
Because you see, for me, I don't sometimes maybe I can say maybe when I look at things, sometimes persons will want to do things for you, but then at another point, people will take you for granted, depending on the type of personality that you have. Or listen to me, if I can really actually save, knowing that if you ask for something and I say to you, no, you don't push the issue, you don't force the issue, you don't come again, you'll go ahead and do it. I'll just maybe say no. If you're really desperate and in need, maybe you try. But for me, if I ask you to do something for me and you say no, I end it right there. If I tell you to do something for me and you're taking too long to do it, I go ahead and do it myself.
So let me ask you, isn't that a bit too impulsive?
Yeah, to an extent, but I'm the type of person, I can't bother with the rejection.
Right.
And I strongly believe in any individual, whether it's the male or female, being independent.
Okay.
And especially for a female, I don't think you need to depend on a man.
So
yes, the man is the head, but certain things you can actually do.
So
I'm not the type to push. You say no, it's a no.
And I guess some of these things you shouldn't even have to be asking in the first place, right?
Thank you.
So, all right. So, for the entire 9 months, is it just this one bad thing that he has done? What about some of the good things? Let me ask you.
You know, because there were points where I can't remember once I was. I don't remember. We were in the bedroom and we were discussing.
My girl, you know, you start off exciting a while ago. You're just boring. We were in the bedroom. I go say yeah. And I said, we were discussing, I was like,
no, not like that. And we're there having a little discussion and, you know, I started to say that I don't feel as if I am first place. I think you put others before me, even your friends.
Okay.
And surprisingly, I don't know what came over him or, you know, what really led to the reaction. The next thing I knew, his hands were on my throat.
What?
No, this is a woman that, yes, this is a woman that is pregnant. This is a woman that is carrying your children. Right? This is somebody that you're supposed to love. It's not like you're having an argument, which at the same time, no matter how arguments might flare, I strongly believe instead of you start a fist fight or so, you might say certain things that you're ending up regret to try and walk it out. But this person does turn and grab, and then for the reason grabbing my throat, I don't know. And when the tears started to come from my eyes and I screamed, he let go, and I was like, okay, I just got up and I just left. I went into the other room and I started to cry, and I was saying to myself, my God, what is really happening here? What have I gotten myself into? Mm-hmm. How can I be pregnant? How can I be carrying your children and you're doing this? And over what? It's not like you hear anything. It's not like it's a infidelity. It's not like a curse. You are, I don't know. Even though nothing should justify for you to do that action.
Wow.
So that I think for me, that was one of the most hurtful things during my pregnancy.
Wow.
And I must say that physical abuse there, it happened only once during the pregnancy, but it should not happen any at all.
True.
So, right? And so then I got back into this little shell. Right? And yeah. There I am, and I'm saying, oh my God, you know, I can't tell anybody about this. You can't tell mommy, you can't tell daddy, you can't tell any of your siblings, you can't tell any of your other relatives, you don't want to tell any of your friends because you don't know what they'll think of you. Because here I was blaming myself. Here I was always thinking that whenever things happen, I would always think that I am the guilty party. I actually did something to trigger that reaction.
Wow. So let me ask, you know, the day of delivery, was he there?
What? For what section?
The delivery.
For the delivery.
Yes, you know, yes, and very much so excited.
Wow, he was
I must say, was very much excited, but when it came on to purchasing certain items, it was like everything has to split. It's not like, you know, some fathers will be so anxious and excited to say, okay, this is needed for the baby, that is needed for the baby. No.
Yeah, hold on a little bit. May I try to find some good in him, though? Hold on a little, take time with me.
Osh.
Me say, hey.
Me know that he has skirt on too, you know.
Me co-host couple times double R fist in there, you know. I tell you the truth. But I'm trying to let's take it slow. On the day of delivery, was he there?
Yes, he was there. I must say, he was there. He stayed for the entire process. He took pictures during the delivery. Yes.
When I said during, hold on. When I said during, in the?
Yes.
So it's when something comes up, bop, and go back down, so bop.
No, but you see, he was right there.
Lord,
so
mercy.
I mean, that point for me now, I really felt special. I really felt careful. I really felt like, yes, this person wanted to be there, is here, because not a lot of mothers have that. Mm-hmm. And so I mean, he was there. I didn't do the natural birth. I did a C-section.
Okay.
And so based on that, you know. I was there the night before. I checked in the evening before, and then, you know, the morning, bright and early, he was there.
Wow.
You know, and he stayed through the process. As I said, he took pictures, so you see everything. And, I mean, right after, he ensured that he went with them to ensure that they were fine, to ensure that they were the right babies, coming back to me and everything. So, you know, and he stayed by me throughout that period, as in during when I was in the hospital.
Wow.
And you know,
he even took leave, which I had to commend. But then at the same point, you know, when you reach home, yes, the your bundles of joy is here, and I mean, so it that feeling, it changes. So now you're a dad and everything. Yes. And then, but it lasts about, you know, that support that the mother needs. So it's not just about the children, and I think at times persons take that away from the mother. It's not just about, yeah, when babies come and children come into the world, it's a different thing, and so most focus is placed on them. But at the same time, the mother might be neglected, and it can't be so, because after that process, there's so much. It's like it's a new feeling, your body changes. Your body trying to get back to the way that it was. And one of the things is that sometimes your body never get back to that stage if you don't get the proper rest that it needs. And for me, I being at home for that period of time with the babies, you know, I had support. Yes, I must say, from my family members, from my mom, but then at a point they had to go. And then here I am, don't even reach 6 weeks yet, and you know, doing that surgery, you know, but let's say you have 6 weeks or more to really recuperate. And I can tell you, at 3 weeks, I was washing baby clothes.
Wow.
And here is not like, my husband can't wash. My husband has never washed out anything for the babies before, right? And so there I was washing. But, you know, I must say that I am a blessed woman. Mm-hmm. In terms of, I've always have had help. I'd always have persons looking out for me. And so I remember even once I was out there washing after
right,
the rain.
On.
I just went out of my brand.
Give me a second. Remember where you're at. We're going to the 11 o'clock break. Don't hang up. And we'll soon get back. Just remember where you were, right?
Sure.
Yeah, it's now 11 o'clock, ladies and gentlemen. The time is brought to you by VJ Printing Services. Don't go nowhere, because the conversation continues.
Architects, draftsmen, and surveyors, get your drawings printed in high-quality professional standards. We can satisfy your printing needs. Whether it is for presentation to your clients or for submitting building and subdivision application, make it VJ Printing Services. Whether drawing by hand or with computer-aided softwares, we will plot your negatives and print the copies as you need. We do high-quality white paper printing that is water-resistant and never fades, unlike traditional blueprint. For more information, call VJ Printing at 893-2266.
Again, Friendship Networking Group presents their second annual Fish Fry at Island View Bar and Grill. Come to the first and last on Friday, July 29th to get your scrumptious fish dishes, available from 12 noon until. The cost for the ticket, only $800. And you can purchase your ticket from the Island View Bar. Part proceeds in aid of charity, so support for a good cause.
Now on your bono.
Ladies, something is on for you on a Tuesday night.
Smoothie.
No more loneliness. Now you have Prestige, your ultimate companion. Experience this musical charm with charismatic passion. So innovative and more interactive.
From 9 to 12 midnight.
On Styles FM. Smoothie with Prestige. Don't miss it.
I'm done. A whole heap of money I man spent on an event here, you know. So me have to make sure it promote proper.
Yo, no say nothing. Link Styles FM bought them summer bonus package.
Summer bonus package. I want that.
$5,000, 1 week party promo shillings. $10,000, 2 week party promo shillings. Me say ads, mentions, interview, giveaway, straight styling. 2869216 or 4395160. Link them now.
No,
Styles FM summer bonus package. Conditions apply.
Yep. So we're back, ladies and gentlemen. We're talking to that strong black woman, right? And we were talking about during pregnancy, then we went into delivery, and then after pregnancy, that's where we were. What were you saying now?
Yes, I would say that, you know, that the support that you would have fully needed when you're at home, you understand the assistance, that full assistance, it wasn't fully there. Yes, I mean...
So let me ask you, what about domestic, like in the kitchen, cooking? Did he do that for you?
What?
Or he bought him come home at evening time with some nice Chinese food or some island grill or something?
You know, funnily enough, as you say that, we hardly went out. And it reached a point where in the relationship, as you speak to that, you've never been children, you know, you say, we need time for ourselves, we need to go out. But every time I've gotten an excuse, majority of the time I get excuses, I don't have any funds right now.
When you say Ali go out to him, you mean like him Ali carry out?
Yeah, we hardly go out, as in whether go out to eat, to watch a movie, to just drive somewhere. Majority of the time when we're actually going out, I am the one that plans it. I'm the one that asks for it. And then sometimes when I even ask, I'm told, no, there is no funds, or I have to go ahead and find the funds because I just really want to go out.
But that sound like, that sound like your high-priced woman then, man, because if you go one little place, go buy two Chinese food and you spend like one three-pack or one four-pack, or if you go watch two movies, if I even the one with the pretty glasses, them, when they're in 3D, with the 3D sitting them, not about $1,000, $1,200 per person that, and you buy two popcorn.
I wonder if they call and listen to what daddy would have say. It will own a man knock on the head like, here you're gone right back at the money thing where she just a talk about
with
the slippers. I saw on the mentality there, you
know? No,
I see thing happen with the slippers, you know?
No, I say, them little something there, that's not enough.
But if me had, if him had bring me out and me ready for go, it better be somewhere good.
No.
Thank you. But then and at the same time, you do find places that you can go. I don't think I'm wrong with how I believe regarding myself or the perception of myself. I think I'm a woman that is easy to please. I'm not fussy.
Yeah.
To me, it's the thought that counts. So if you take home a rose for me, I mean, you take home a dinner, as you say, if it's even island grill, if it's even to say, all right, then we're even going to KFC, my God.
Don't to carry out.
Don't to eat, to talk, right? That is hardly done. And then majority of the time, when as the kids got older, you'll find it that me and the kids will have to, you know, go places and we'll sit together and eat because you're not available.
So you and the kids going out together more than you and him are.
Yes.
So let me ask you a question. I know that you said that you're studying right now. How supportive is he as it relates to you excelling, you know, in your academic studies?
The support is not 100%. I would consider it 50, and sometimes below 50.
And sometimes below 50?
Yes, because, wow. you know, when you start, then guess what? Don't stay home tonight. You can go out with your friends. Them. You can go and do an online. You can go and study. Or guess what? You need a friend. Them. You might need a little company. So, all right, then you can invite over a friend because the space is there. You guys can do an online, and I'll deal with the children. At times when I even say that I'm going out to do an online, there comes the vex. There comes the argument. Right? There comes the change in mood.
And when you say all night is for study.
Study, yeah. As in, so you might get up and leave. You know, when you're doing all night, you don't leave early. So say you try to leave at 10 or 9.
Right,
and
right.
And I always try to leave after they fall asleep.
So in other words, he would just be there in case them wake up and him give them little buckler or something that pre-prepared and everything.
Yes.
So you're saying that whenever that time comes, what happens?
There'll be attitude being given, there'll be excuses.
Like what, sir? What kind of excuse?
He has to go out. He's not feeling well, so he can't stay with them by himself. Or why do I need to go out and study? All those type of things. Why do I need to go out and study? Right? And at points, you know, it's really hard. It's really hard being a young mother, a new mother, studying and working. And in my field, it's really not easy because, you know, when it comes on to accounting, when it comes on to finances, it's not an easy thing to deal with. When it comes on to auditing,
because accounting duties normally take you to work beyond regular working hours.
Thank you.
So how does he cope with that?
Not so well, you know, because. You know, I at points I was told that I'm caught up in my work, but it's not about being caught up in my work. When I do something, I like to do it to the best of my ability.
Well, my knowledge of your working environment is one that there is not an option. You have to, it has to be correct. Especially when you are in the chartered accounting field, you know, and you work for big audit firms. So tell me some of your experiences in terms of what he does whenever you're out working late.
When I on the way home and I'm calling to say, all right, you can get up, you can open up for me, apparently sometimes he doesn't answer. Or when I come in, you know, you might expect and you're exhausted and you're tired, you need a little massage. No, you're being told, okay, I need a massage also, right? Or you come in and you're trying to have a conversation and it's like no time for you.
So let me ask you, you give the massage?
Sometimes, not all the time.
And do you get it any at all?
Yes, at times I do get it.
Okay, at least it kind of balance. May I try, put on one notch over the side of fame again. I'm going two notch fame over here, so the good part. Yeah.
That leads me to a question. How long of a period would a good time last? Like between
good question.
Yeah, you know, how long of a stretch would you have a good time with him, whether it's in days or weeks or months?
Or just sporadic.
Without incident free, how much of a time would it last when he's in a really good mood and
you know, the really good mood, as in just like that good mood and make you feel like, oh, the first time you guys meet and I've fallen in love again.
Yes, that kind of
mood. It doesn't pass the week.
Wow.
Right? And then I might say, like, I don't know if it is so, it could be so, but I can't really see if I've ever gone through, like, a two-month period or so. And there's not an argument or a month period and there's not something causing some kind of disrupt or causing me to feel less than how I should feel. Because even in the case, I mean, I've been going through this for years. Now I would consider myself having on a lot of weight. And before, I mean, even if I had children, I went down even slimmer than I was before I had them. And here this person was always complaining about my weight, complaining about my tummy. Right?
Your tummy, what you must say, your belly big?
Yes. You know, even at points when it really never seemed that big. I mean, my God, you just gave birth to two.
No, hold on. Stop right there. Every woman said their belly no big. Every woman said their belly no big.
My belly no big, what?
Oh, please, listen. listen to me, well. When you compare, listen to me. I'm not going to say that, yes. You don't rise a bit, but when you look at that point, the tummy that I had,
yeah,
right, it was fine to see that you just gave birth to two. As I said to you, I went down slimmer than I was even before.
Okay.
I got pregnant, and at that stage, at that point, when even co-workers were looking on me and saying to me, boy, you need to put on some weight, you're too slim. No, we don't like you like this, man, you look like you have AIDS or something. But
yeah.
I didn't tell you that it was because I was breastfeeding. And at that point, when they were saying that, boy, you need to put on back that weight, we don't used to you like this. Here, my husband was saying to me, your belly too big.
Yeah.
You need to do something about it. You're not attractive. When you say, but I don't understand. Oh, and you're telling me that everybody else is blind.
Wow.
You know how that feels?
No.
Well, no, you can't answer because you will not know how that
feels. All right, let me ask now. I'm going to get to the more serious part now of the show. Have you ever thought that he's having an affair?
Yes. I know that he has done it on several occasions in the past.
No, well,
but
well,
to tell the truth, he has never admitted to it.
I can
even clearly remember one birthday. I spent my entire birthday by myself. We got up in the morning. I think this is a birthday that I can never forget.
Wow.
Right? We got up in the morning and he wanted us to make love. No, yes, this is my birthday and I think that choice should have been mine. You know, I started to get calls. And surprisingly, one of my relatives was calling me and he just got so upset, got up out of the bed, kissed him teeth, just put on some clothes, jumped in his car and never returned until almost 6 o'clock in the evening.
Really?
And he left from about 7 o'clock, minutes after 7 in the morning. No call, nothing to check up on me to say, all right, this is your brother. And I'm saying, I was there and I was wondering. So all I had to do, I spent my day crying. This was my birthday. I spent it crying and I spent it preparing meals for myself. And I spent it talking to my mom on the phone and talking to my best friend on the phone because I didn't know what else to do.
Did you had it, you had the kids with you then?
No. I didn't have the kids at that point.
So, all right. You mentioned that. how do you know that he has done these things? He has never admitted to it. But what are your proof to fact?
Listen to me. For example, in that case, tell me where could you have possibly been? You get up on your other half's birthday. You get up. Just because of a phone call from a relative and you wanted to have sex on the other person's birthday. We have all day to do that. That was a holiday we had all day. And you're going to get up from 7 o'clock and don't return until 6 in the evening?
Well,
come on. Here you are with somebody and every time you try to find fault, you don't try to help the person to lose the weight or to whatever, try to encourage this person. Here every time you're complaining about weight or this person looks, right? No, something has to be wrong. Yeah, one has to think that, are you comparing me to someone else?
Well, all right. So if this was a different kind of conversation, I would have a debate on that particular example, but in him, do you see him? Because you mentioned that it's more you believe that he has done it more than once, twice, so on and so forth. Would you see that a situation where it's a boy him have multiple persons, are there just this one or two persons where yeah them that the people and where, if anything, a demi rely upon me? No, no. I'm trying to figure out his what would have probably influenced him not wanting to what I would say is serve you. You know, the woman that's the mother of his kids, and you know you take care of him, you do your cooking and you blend up and house ever clean. You know, everything good from that side. You know, why is it? You know, do you think that based on his behavior and maybe spending habits, if there's any, of him not being able to care for you because there might be someone else?
Yes. And yes, I would. And one of the reasons for this is too that, as I said, I don't ask so much. When it comes onto my hair, when it comes onto my nails, when it comes onto buying stuff for myself, taking care of myself, I do that all on my own. When it comes on, I don't say to you at the end of any given month, oh, you must give me cash, you must give me funds. I think it's a given that you should. Or, you know, are you sorry, babe, see a 10 grand here, see a 5 grand here, whatever it is. It's yours. Take it, do something, or you might get up and want to treat me on Monday, babes. You go under your hair and I might treat something. I've never had that. Whether it be for a birthday, whether it be for an anniversary, I've never had that. Whether it be for a Mother's Day, I've never had that.
Wow.
That being wowed on an anniversary or on a birthday, I've never gotten that.
Let me ask you a question. What do you see in him?
You know,
can almost answer that.
I looking at it, I saw someone that that needed my love, right? Needed my support, which I gave. I saw someone that I really actually thought could have been my best friend, right? I saw someone that this person I could grow old with. But then as time goes by, as time went by, I get to understand, listen to me, what you saw at the beginning is not it. What you saw, this person coming and pretending to be so innocent, so shy, not opening up, not a wild person, not a person that goes around and sleep with different females or stuff like that or carry on. No, I didn't see that at first. But then when you get to know this person, I didn't see somebody that could ever be abusive either. Didn't come out.
All right, let me rephrase my question. What did you see in him for you?
For me?
Yeah, because your answer a while ago sounded to me that from early you recognize that he is trouble and he needs you. You are trying to fix something. That's my analogy. It may not be right, but it's based on what you answered.
Thing? Yeah.
Right.
But actually your analogy is right, you know, because for me, looking back at it now, I think, and it's not even think, I know, fear was driven into me at an early stage, and just not only fear. You're from a small group of friends. You're from a family that, listen to me, this bagaman business don't work. This change-changing man not going to work. Those type of things, they don't work. So here you see your mother sticking with this one man for how many years through thick and thin, no matter what, even at points when you wonder, my God, why are you staying? Right? Yes, he's our father, but why are you staying? Here you go up, you see your sister. You only know in your lifetime, you only know your sister to ever be with two persons in her entire life. You don't know anybody else. And so you try to stay along those lines, and then your friends' relationships are working out. You have your close friends and their relationships are working out. They are being treated. And so then I never wanted to feel as if, listen to me, I can't keep someone. I don't know how to keep a relationship. Something is wrong with me. And so I held on. And as I said, because for me, fear was driven in early, because here this person even tell me, you know, if you ever try to leave, me finish, you know, man, no ever want you again. Me done you. And then, you know, you're growing up and in your teenagers are like, okay, you know how you grow up in your church and not even realize, so listen to me. Woman can't done. That's what the song says. Who say woman can't done? And
yeah.
Then, you know, so you actually believe all of those things. Listen to me, this man can't ruin down there. This man can't damage down there. And so you kept those things and you held on to those things, and then you put you in this shell, and then this fear came, and every time you were supposed to leave, you thought to yourself, I'm not good enough. Nobody else would want me. I'm not good enough. I don't deserve much more. And so your self-esteem got lowered by someone.
Wow.
I'm going to go back to something that Ruth said. And when you answer this question, I didn't get a sense from it that you came into that equation initially at all, in terms of what you needed or you just, it was all about what he was about and what he needed instead of you. I didn't hear you come in there anywhere. So, but then you just kind of elaborate to see, you know, the reasons maybe why. You understand what I mean? So that
yes.
She answered your question about him like it was just about him and like needs.
Like she wanted
and
to, right. She wanted to be a satisfying woman. She wanted to submit. Well, let me ask you this though.
Yeah.
And I said this are the serious part of the show now, you know. How I'm sure that men have flirted with you. Right? How do you feel? Have there been any temptations, thought of, you know, of infidelity? because of what's happening in your relationship, your need for attention?
You mean with if I would or if I did?
No. Well, if there was any thought of it in terms of like men coming on to you, giving you, because you said that other person were saying that you're looking good and stuff like that, but your person at home wasn't. You know, what are some of the thoughts that came to mind? Were there any temptations?
To an extent, there were temptations, but apart from that, those points now, hearing this and looking at others and viewing other relationships and getting compliments, and it kind of started to open my eyes more, kind of started to say, no man, these persons can't be lying. So many persons cannot be drawn to you, right? Whether it be on an attractive basis or just for a friendship, and you're not getting it here, something has to be wrong. And so it started me wanting me to just get out, trying to find ways in getting out. And yes, sometimes it might come across your mind and solicit to me, you know, this girl this way, can I really actually, you know, go to that guy, or, you know, but at the same time, there is this fear. Right? There is this other thing regarding commitment, and you say, listen to me, I said to this person, for better, for worse, and so, you know, I'm going to stick it out. I'm going to just trust God and hope that things will change for the better.
We say ride or die.
So yeah. Kind of that way.
My part B to that, no, is there ever a time you were tempted to put your hands around his throat or let him have that pot of soup or porridge or something?
I'm coming. Yes, now, what were you saying?
I was saying my follow-up to what Daddy would just ask you is, was there ever a time you were tempted to put your hands around his throat or let him have that pot of porridge or soup or something?
In other words, you ever feel like if you give him a dose of your own medicine?
Medicine, right.
Yes, you know. Yes.
Like you sit down and plot what you would do, because it's just like you're at that point where you're at the edge and you're just thinking that, like, sit down and put the plan in place, but just not able to carry it out?
No, I don't think they're not able to carry it out. I mean, sometimes you really actually look and you think and you say to yourself, you know, you just look and say, would I do, how would he feel if I would have done this? Or if I should do this, what would be the reaction? But then it's never for me to fully go the extent. Because, you know, when something is just not a part of you, it's just not a part of you.
So you tell me, say, you know, and me knows at the time of the night, me can't say this. Yeah, say, you never feel like texting and clout him yet?
What?
You never feel like texting and clout him?
No, yeah, that part different, no.
And that means, man,
that part is different.
Get to that familiar man part, no. Talk to me.
And you're like, and you're saying, listen to me, how do you trust me that much to lie beside me? You don't feel one of these nights I just get up, you know, when I'm talking about throw out oil in my ears or something. And I'm like, how you know that I wouldn't do that, right? And sometimes you're there and you're like, you can't just...
Yeah.
You feel like you really actually strangle this person.
So the thought actually came across my mind, look, you're not going to do it, doing it, because we're not going to look for you, you know. You are we playing 4th Augustus?
Well, you see, that is it. So that is it. So yes, the thoughts are there, you know, you think about those type of things, but then that side kicks in and says, listen to me, I can't give up my freedom like that.
Question, and this is a very strong one. Do you fear him?
Still.
Looking at what I went through and how I stayed and even sometimes how things still affect me, I would say yes. But this is something that I'm trying to overcome.
What do you fear most?
Apart from, say, fearing that he might do something drastic, I fear being humiliated, you know, you actually think about what persons might think of you, or persons might say, or persons will actually believe him, or would they really believe you?
But that leads me to say, why would you care what anybody wants to think? And there's no need to explain anything to anybody, as far as I am concerned. And even if it's my own mother come and ask me, and I feel like nobody deserves an explanation, you know, because who knows. Well,
yeah, you know that's something that I'm that's a point that I'm trying to get at, because
okay.
I'm not that type of person.
Okay.
So that's where I'm trying to get at. That who cares? Because, you know, persons always try to say, trying to instill it in me. You know, my best friend always say it to me. Who cares?
Yes, because they'll talk
you know,
either
you
way.
You know what you're going through, nobody. You know what you're going through.
Right.
So it doesn't care what persons want to think. Let it be. So even if his family members want to say anything, want to care, and you know what you're in, you're going through it.
Well,
so that's something that I'm trying to learn to deal with. And trying to accept.
I applaud
right?
you.
Right? Because when you ask me certain things, I'll always try to, like, give you the explanation.
Oh,
and, like, wait, by right, you really don't need to. Yeah, the bottom line is that you really don't need to explain.
True.
You don't need to try and justify. So it's like, as what, you know, make your neighbor near your neighbor, yeah. So that's something that I'm really just trying to. Just when I say yes, it's a yes. When it's a no, it's just a no.
True.
If it's just not your business, it's just
not your business. All right, we're gonna
I'm
go.
I'm still learning how to do that.
We're gonna go to the 11:30 break, our final break of the night, and we're just gonna probably talk to you for just 5 minutes more. I know it's late. Last week we kept you up till midnight. I'm not gonna do that tonight. So after the break, I'm just asking you to give us about 5 minutes more of your time.
Not there.
All right, it's now 11:30. We're going to a break.
Stars FM, you're my number one.
Architects, draftsmen, and surveyors, get your drawings printed in high-quality professional standards. We can satisfy your printing needs. Whether it is for presentation to your clients or for submitting building and subdivision application, make it VJ Printing Services. Whether drawing by hand or with computer-aided softwares, we will plot your negatives and print the copies as you need. We do high-quality white paper printing that is water-resistant and never fades, unlike traditional blueprint. For more information, call VJ Printing at 893-2266.
Portlanders, Acan Auto Technology, located at 33 Bomber Crescent, Port Antonio. Visit us for all your auto repair and servicing. We offer computerized wheel alignment, computerized wheel balancing, suspension checks, AC repair, inspection, and all your auto repair needs. For a complete auto repair and service, visit or call Acan Auto Technology today at 715-5205. And remember, we are located at 33 Bonbrook Crescent.
WAW, the Caravan of Love. What a Wednesday. This and every Wednesday from 9 a.m. until 1 on the p.m. Strongly takes you on a caravan of love songs. 4 hours of love songs on Stars FM, the People Station, 96.1, 96.7, www.stylzfm.com. Don't miss it. What a Wednesday, the Caravan of Love.
Yo, my dad, a whole heap of money I man spent on an event here, you know. So me have to make sure it promote proper.
Yo, nothing. Link Styles FM bought them summer burn-up package.
Summer burn-up package? I want that.
$5,000, 1 week party promo shillings. $10,000, 2 week party promo shillings. Me say ads, mentions, interview, giveaway, straight styling. 2869216 or 4395160. Link them now.
No!
Styles FM summer burn-up package. Conditions apply.
Summer burn-up package. All right, so we're going to go back into the call. What I'm going to do before we hang up, I'm going to read probably two or so of our WhatsApp messages. I don't know if there's anyone want to send any message or ask any
question. Right.
Now is the opportunity. We have just 5 minutes left with our strong lady. So here's what someone has to say. And this person is from overseas. So we're gonna read yours now. It's what, 374? No, 347. That's your area code overseas.
You want me to go ahead, Daddy Ruth?
Sure.
Hi, Styles. I think she's strong. I don't think I need to tell her anything. She seems to be on her way to a better place. I just want her to know she's not alone. We all feel disappointed sometimes. It's just very important to pick up the pieces of your life and go on. I had the same thing happen to me, but my abuse was mental, not physical. I realize that you have to love yourself more and change your lifestyles for the better. People can hold you back from opportunities. I told him that my child is my first priority and my future is no longer his concern. I'm reaching for the stars because I have a child that needs me to be strong.
Great. Thank you, 347.
And Jacko from Clear Spring is saying, yo, the relationship that she got between the woman was God when she take him off her. I don't know. You get that?
Yeah, that was from last week.
Oh.
The call is still on, right?
Yeah,
because someone last week was saying that, because you mentioned in the early part of the days that he had someone that was overseas. So what Jacko from Clear Spring is saying that the lady where you're taking away from is supposed to glad for you. You know, and someone last week after we hung up actually said that the possibility is there that he hasn't gotten over that person, which is why he's behaving this way. I don't necessarily share the same view because for so long, I don't know what.
That has been years.
Yeah, that would have been years ago when y'all were
unless he's blaming
were kids.
You for that breakup, unknowingly.
You know.
Punishing you.
Really. Have you guys gotten counseling?
At any point?
We have went to counseling before, and you know, I've been told that. You know, when you mention it back again, I've been told that. You know, I guess hearing both sides. I can tell you that this person is someone that is controlling. And we have been to counseling and the counselor doesn't know any of the two parties. And when they started to talk and try to explain and see where I'm coming from and what he was doing, and you know, they tried to say, listen to me, you can't behave this way, you can't say these things to your wife, you can't do these things. I mean, it ended up that he wanted the sessions to end. And I remember at one point we were discussing it and I said, listen to me, we have gone to counseling. I was told, listen, you were the one who wanted to go.
So he wanted to go to counseling, and at the same time, he wanted it to end when maybe things weren't going his way.
Yes, yes. And then, so, you know, then you're told that, oh, no, you were the one who wanted the counseling. You were the one who wanted to go. So it's like, okay, I didn't believe that there needed any counseling. I just went ahead because you wanted me to.
All right, hold on. Someone is calling us from overseas. Good night. Yes, yes, Dan.
Yeah, this is Trinidad. Listen now. She has two kids, right?
Yeah, she has two kids.
No.
Go on again. How old are they?
No.
Phone line, I break up, madam. Go on again.
No. How old are the kids?
Okay. How old are your kids?
Three.
3 years old.
3 years old.
Twins.
All right. Yeah. One thing in her growing up is it, but she wasn't as social as she could have. I don't know if it's like parents probably it's parents that might have reduced social activities like. Including our dating, and I think this is not fine in our society. You know, we parents are reluctant to submit them, especially them daughters, to support them and keep that before 18 years old. Now,
if you come out and do go on again. Come out and do
no, so go and allow them to go and date.
Oh, go and date before they are 18.
Yeah.
So yeah, I said she was inexperienced then.
Yeah, but well, I'm proud of, again.
Dandan, I tell you the truth, I now pick up clearly where I say because of the, me know the internet thing probably slow up still.
Hello?
Yeah. Go through me, Dan.
I can't.
When I pick it up so clear, Dan, I know the internet because it's a different connection we have to use. But closing, as I said, I don't want to keep it too long. You have to go rest up, figure out work. Whoa, phone line, I ring off. Hold on there. Hello?
Yeah.
Partially. Go on, we can see if I get you better.
Yeah, no. That was our upbringing. She wasn't exposed to her like that. We just got that.
So, Dandan. Dandan, yeah. My question to you is, what was he exposed to why he behaves like an animal?
No. The reason I ask that is because she herself seemed as if she had a low self-esteem of herself. Growing up, she never had that reinforcement.
She has said the reason for the low self-esteem, you know, because of the kind of regime where the Virgin put upon her. I remember from early part, him kind of rough her up on way too, you know.
From school days, remember?
From school days, you know.
They were together from school, you know, so.
Yeah, but that might would have been her own experience.
Wrong with that.
But what I say is, a person growing up in another world, can't expect them to have a skill after one experience, actually. You know what I say? You can't, enough.
Dan. Dan.
Good.
It call now come through clear. You hear me, Dan? Me might have got call you back and conference the call to the other line. Here.
Alright, cool.
Yeah. Alright, no, cause we're gonna keep it much longer and thing. But
okay.
Any me have so much question for asking and if we gonna start right now. Is there any chance of you and him getting back together?
No, I don't see it.
None at all?
No, I don't see it. Not based on what is happening, no. Here this person is trying to tarnish your reputation, trying for you to lose your job, you know, trying to let your friends see you in a negative light, trying to destroy you.
When they say try to make you lose your work, what do you mean by that?
Calling, telling lies, you know, saying that this person, you know, as chartered accountants, for you to be saying that, you know, this person is involved in fraud, when you're stating to persons that you're saying, did you do your due diligence, did you do your background checks, did you check her the references, those type of things, it will raise a question in mind.
So right. how your employer sees all of this? Are you being investigated, scrutinized, treated any differently?
You know, surprisingly, no. Because you see, I can tell you this: your life speaks for you. Your actions speak. And as I said to you, when it comes on to my work, when it comes on to doing whatever you have to do, you just get it done, you just do it. And so that speaks for you. And sometimes when you don't even realize that it speaks for you, it is when you're at that point and when you're in the state of needing, you realize that, listen to me. So yes, this person is trying to break you, trying to destroy you, but then you have persons who actually are wise enough to know and to understand and is able to differentiate. And I said, oh, you know, maybe if you're working with some other places or you're working with some persons without trying to find out what is happening, without, you know, it would have been a case where you just hear you got to go without even knowing the reasons why.
Well, my dear, as a lady told me, an incident happened, not to me, but I was privy to the incident and a older lady was sitting there and she's saying that when your reputation is good, there is no need for you to defend it. It will defend itself. And just like oil and water, your reputation will surface. So yes, there's no need for you to walk around and explain to anybody and think that just because I'm saying this, everybody's going to believe. Your reputation is going to speak for itself.
Yes, that's so true.
Yes, yeah, so I actually wrote it down. It's just that it's not in this form, because when she said it, I actually wrote it down because it was so profound. You know, it made total sense. So,
what do you see the future for you and him regarding the whole? You and him have assets together. You guys have a child together. Children together. What do you foresee? I know it can't be easy for you to be paying mortgage plus rent. You're walking away, leave all of that?
For your sanity, yes. For your happiness, yes. For your peace of mind, yes.
Wow. So, it's gonna go to whatever process there is to might just lead to a divorce, right?
Yes.
Okay. So you have to find like a Christian man next then.
You know, that would be really good, you know, but let me tell you something, that the truth, and it's just life, when it comes on to individuals, it's not about being a Christian or not, it's about your personality.
Okay.
It's up to the individual, because trust me, you have some men in church, based on how they behave or treat their wife, you'd really wonder if this is really a man of God.
Wow.
Or even their children, at times you'll have to wonder. So, you know, it's just about really trusting God, lining up yourself, and just praying and asking for direction. When you're choosing your relationship, so that be the male choosing or the female choosing, and as I can say, even in my case, you know, when you see the signs and when you get the signs, work with it, because there will be signs. So if you see the signs, don't sidetrack it. Don't try to justify anyone's bad actions.
Good words.
Just
close
try
off.
And let it go and just trust and also listen to me. Mm-mm, this is not for me. Set your standard and just, each individual actually knows what they want. And then if you know what you want, don't try to compromise too much. Yes, compromising will come in place, but don't try to compromise everything. Don't try to neglect or put your values aside and just try to please the other party, because it's not a one-way thing, it's a two-way thing.
True. Well, thank you very much once again. Nice way of closing it. It's a two-way thing, and have your values, stick to it, and if there's anything to compromise, ensure that it's something that you're still gonna be gaining, or win-win situation. And have all the rest, love, and we at Styles FM, and I know the Real Talk listeners, wish you all the best.
Thank you.
Don't hesitate to be safe.
All right, love.
All right, sure. Okay.
Yeah, thanks again.
All right, sure, bye.
Whoa.
I'm going back to what Dandan was kind of trying was saying.
Dandan, may I look for your number in my phone? May not have it. I could have sworn I did. I could have sworn we have done this three-way conferencing thing before. I'm not seeing it in this phone. So you can probably even call back the other line. I can't get the number. I mean, just do the conference call same time. Yeah, you as know, you were saying?
He was going back as to how maybe she was brought up and socialized. And I won't hesitate to say that, call me something, but I just never liked the fact that him approach, oh, she was brought up and socialized, has to be in her reason for ending up the victim, right, to whatever he was trying to do to her, because manipulators are like that. He was older and have mastered a certain kind of heart already. Him do it and him find out say it work, and him just continue doing it. So me kind of feel a way say him start this. So what about the young man or the man, him big man now, you know?
So let me ask a question. What if, and it's like one of those impossible tasks. I don't even, what if we could get him to call us?
I would love I would love no, to hear the next side of the story. Because there are always three sides.
Wow.
I would love for him to call, because that would give us an insight that we would into his mind and his maybe he could probably give a reason. Because from what I'm getting, this man have some multiple personality going on there. He could switch from being Mr. Nice Guy to Mr. Jekyll and Dr. Hyde.
And Hyde.
Right. So he seems he could just switch like that. From one thing to the next, from one personality to the next. You know, so
I'm wondering, I didn't want to go down that road. I'm wondering if he's dangerous.
I would not hesitate to think he is. You realize I tell her to be safe?
Yes, I realize that.
I told her to be safe. In not so much words, because those kind of persons,
it, you know, sad to say, I was actually thinking more so last week than this week, because I wanted to get more out. I was more concentrating on whatever information I could pull. But last week, I was wondering to myself, honestly, what if, and let's hope it doesn't happen, she makes the news.
That's why I told her to be safe, because right, even talking to her, I'm like, I wonder if him all outside our house, a stalker or something.
Yeah, Dan, a number missing, Cassidy. Apparently, the phone I get problems, so Cassidy miss out one of the number them. So call back now, please, so Cassidy can get the rest of the number.
You see, I've done research on this.
Mm-hmm.
I'll explain to you why I went to do the research. But those kind of people.
You know why, man? Are you only man in short this time?
Those kind of people don't know how to let go, because they it's like they feel a sense of ownership, and if you try to pull away, they're gonna find a way or try to find a way to hold on to you.
Why?
You know, call back on the 453 number.
Yeah,
please.
One caller coming a while gone. We kind of miss out on it, please. So. Me no know. Me kinda. Why me tell the truth?
Dwight said nothing. He want hear the man side of the story. Sorry, Dwight, but there's always three sides to a story. So
why, Dwight? Me kinda share yours. I agree with it.
Sounds
like
I'm good night.
I agree with the Dwight.
Yeah, I'm here to shout to back to them. Mm-hmm. You know, someone said it run long, catch. I was making some calls. Okay. Is that lady there?
Mm-hmm.
I know. I have a friend who she got a shot, but thank God she was living in the same situation. You know.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so I would like her for this next week, because I'm gonna hear her, I wanna talk to her about it, and because you gotta be careful what you do knowing, because
repeat what you just said. You have a friend in that same situation. What you said about next week?
I said I don't have enough credit, but I can talk to her upon my like an issue. She has to be safe, you know, because what
okay.
Yes.
Guys like those know will lick our head because they wanna take everything. They need a house, they need you know,
right.
Can I say?
Yes.
That the thing that they have a little thing them called beneficiaries, and especially, you know.
Yeah, I hope she's listening.
Depends on how the type of person he is, you see, say?
I wouldn't trust him as far as I can to him. And I can imagine that I can't even lift him up, so I wouldn't trust him.
Depends, because we don't know him, right?
No, I'm just saying, as a female, a female's strength can't be that of a man. No matter how much you try. So I'm just saying that, you know. You know the term that people use, say, I can't throw you as far as me can lift you. Something like that.
Yeah, well, I'll check this report to the police and make sure say them have him as, you know.
Okay, I would answer, but you're saying enough. Okay.
All right, madam, respect.
All right, thank you. You see, a lot of times they will tell you that as long as the person don't touch you or... try to arm you in some kind of ways, then sometimes there's not much. Yes, Dan.
Yeah,
we're hearing you more clearly now. Could you just go ahead and tell us, share your views that you had?
Oh, Now, what I'm going to try to is that I think our problems really... All right, I'm not focused on the guy so much, you know, because I don't really think it's worth it like that. But she's the focus. I think what we're saying, you know, when girls go through a lot in their upbringing, you know, especially in our society, in our Jamaican society, our parents always look out for the girl them and don't want to grow them, like, date and them thing there. So because they're not start dating when they're 14, 15, 16, they're not going to go with guys like that, then they have the experience of what it is.
Dan, I'm going to stop you right there. What experience can a 14, 15, or 16-year-old know?
Hold on, man. I'm talking about the experience of social.
That has nothing to do with the man personality. Me can't tell you that straight up. It has nothing to do with the man personality. And people pretend initially as if they are very nice.
No, but hold on, man. I get to that now. But so what I'm saying is, you see, because she hasn't experienced. You know, she probably don't have the sense of confidence that she herself has many attributes.
It's the same reason why she is where she is, because she started dating him in school.
No, man. I agree with that.
So what kind of experience could she have? That may ask you, you know. If she did a date when she young, then probably she'd have more self-confidence. Me not understand what you say. Because self-confidence not come from dating when you're young.
No, you'll be surprised. All right, you see, in America, parents are for the most part, especially among Caucasian parents, for the most part, allow them kids to go to 12, 13, 14. And you don't find these sort of abusive problems.
Really?
In a Caucasian relationship.
Dan, go back and do your research. Go back and do your research.
No, I tell you.
Go back and do your research. Go back? No, me, I tell you, if you go back and do it. It exists everywhere, and that is one of the main problems right now in this world. The abuse of our women and our children. It don't matter what age you start to date. The boy picking them left up too much.
But what I try to say is to avoid the women being abused, they need to have a sense of being, of strong being.
No, they need a sense of more fathers, more good daddy, to make them feel when man love them and know how a man is to love, how they are supposed to feel when a man love them. That's what they need.
How are they gonna
not dating early.
They learn that through socialization.
No, them learn it from strong fathers. Strong fathers who teach them things so they will know how it feels to have a man love them. No, socializing early or dating early, because that's some of the major problems. It's not coming from a background where them feel love and stable. So therefore, when they go out in the world, they don't need anybody to tell them that, hey, I love you, and hey, you're beautiful, or hey, you're ugly. So therefore, them feel a sense of incompleteness because somebody has tell them they're ugly. Them already know. So when me as a mother and you as a father tell you your child how beautiful they are and let them feel loved, you hug them, you do whatever it is that you are supposed to do to let them feel that way. Nobody can run upon them a road, no matter what age they are.
You are 100% correct.
Dan.
And this is why I was trying to get a sense of all her kids was because
Dan, hold on.
Her kids.
Dan.
Many of her boys are girls. When her kids are grew up and reach teenager, she must encourage them to go out and make more. But when I say experience, I mean, experience.
Hold on a little bit. Hold on a little bit, Dan. 954, what go on? 954. Hello? Person in 954? Yeah, 954.
A person is there, you know. Hello?
Yes. Yeah, man. 954 Carla.
Hello.
Yeah, what go on? Boy, Charm, I tell you the truth, the 954 does not work right.
I know it's not working right because I can hear it out to
be. Yeah.
But, honestly, this is my.
I'd show that still.
Yeah, we'd have way better work. But these kids start late from, remember when I had my last kid, I had a little girl come, she 11 years old and I did work.
She had 11 and a half pitney? The last part then I come through like the line I get back, the line I get worse, Charm. Just after 12 and we have to wrap up with Dandan and reach you to WhatsApp and message here.
Right.
Yeah, me up so next week everything sort out with the phone line. Yeah. Well, at the internet connection are the problem okay. Still.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah, Dandan. We're gonna wrap up yeah. In a bit now, here.
Yeah man, cool man.
Alright, respect.
Tara saying Dandan, cut your crap. Abuse happens at any age. I know young girls that are physically and mentally abused. Anybody else up there? Cassidy. Oh, I hope she's listening. My heart goes out to that lady. I don't think I would want to hear the man part of a story, Dwight. I hope she was listening. I would like to pray for her, I think. I'd like to pray for her. She can WhatsApp me on this number, Dwight.
Yeah, man. Ladies and gentlemen, you know, say midnight, 2 minutes after 12 right now. And we have to thank Olan. How is that? Answer there. Yeah, hello?
Yeah, man. Larry, Connecticut still.
Oh, what are you going, Larry?
Well, I'm not a madman, but what am I to deal with?
I have to disagree with Dandan this week, too.
Why does socializing have anything to do with that? The man is an abuser, right? The man has brainwashed the woman for how much years now.
Yeah.
You know? So, I mean, look at how I started the program late, so because I wasn't able to listen earlier, but we listen every week still, and, you know, but still surprised with Dandan reasoning. That is no, that have nothing to do with anything that was happening to her.
God, why, the brother, I don't even know you, sir, because I know that certain things probably never fit for your play, make sure you never say certain other things still. But you see, since she not say it, I not say it, you know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah. You know? But either way, whether she knows how to socialize or not, that still shouldn't give him the right, you know, to do all the things.
It has nothing to do with what happened.
I think the part where Dan did I say is that if from an earlier age, right, she had gone a certain experience, certain signs would have been easier to identify and deal with it.
Well, stop it.
Hold on, man. Listen what me say, no, man. Listen what me say. Hold on. Yes, when you are being manipulated, if you don't know, say it a go on in your life. Because this a man, I must say, the first man fear.
So what have you done? She got quiet school.
Jesus Christ. We are making it look like, say, hold on, all the way a man. You know what? Hold on, as man. Hold on, my brother. As man. All you think of fight time will get some woman. I trick or treat them and manipulate them. The man never idiot. A simple thing. It's not as we use a manipulation for other things. Him use it for something different. So we can't be like, so we don't know how the manipulating game go. And some woman can go and say that they don't know how the weakness
that
game go.
That is not rational to what happened in the situation. She could have been 40 and he is after that personality. Just like what you say, a tricky is getting that tricky. So don't try to say it.
No. I'm not talking about. I'm not talking about him being an abuser. He's an abuser. Right? That's hands down. But what I'm saying, her ability to identify, say, yo, a time for juggle now, time for move now, because you realize, no, she mentioned a number of things that were happening even before she got married, which is when she in her adult stage. No more adolescent.
But that
right?
had nothing to do with nothing. That rude.
She said, well, I know, she said she recognized that she herself had an internal thing where she had battled with her level of confidence.
Because it's been a long time.
This is because the man a manipulator.
No, but she didn't recognize that until she was an adult.
Right.
But them a friend from school.
But what Dandana said.
He not said nothing because they made a friend from school. So she still started early.
All right, Ewa. It is obvious that everybody fixes it upon one certain thing and we have to look wider than that. Right? If you have experience, you
what experience would she have gotten?
You know that she never get none.
What kind of experience she would have get when she's 14 or 15? All right, Ewa.
All right, Ewa. Make 5 man trick you. If 5 man trick you and number 6 come with the same argument and you don't learn, that means you're a pick.
You don't have that much abuse. You have the same amount of abuse. Whether you're Caucasian, African American, Jamaican, it doesn't matter. It have nothing to do with it. And how many people are allowing their 14 and 15 year old kids to go out and date like that?
Well, on, I think when him said date, he mean getting intimate, you know. There's a legal thing, you know, but remember him started with socializing, you know. Socializing himself still, you know, originally, you know.
That should even and, come up.
And a lot of things that we learn.
How much. It doesn't matter how much you are being socialized with other people. If someone's going to kick the crap out of you, it's nothing going to stop that.
Right, but the next step, but yeah, make sure, so the next time you walk with a knife in your pocket, though.
How you gonna know who
when I walk with a knife?
How you are gonna know
that
who
means
gonna pick you?
If you don't walk with a knife, that means you deserve the next
but
one
you
get.
But if you don't get the kick, what you gonna do about it? If you don't get the kick?
If you don't walk with something to defend yourself and your parents say you got a self-defense class, that means that you deserve the next one you get because you don't know the environment or the possibility or the volatility of the environment we're living in.
Then you know what? She's going to go to jail. Her kid's going to be without a mother, which
we're not talking about no. We're talking about finding my picnic.
More than they need a kid because the person they're going to
tell mom with you on that.
Has she gone to the police? Has she reported to the police? You know, has she brought charges against him in any way, shape, or form?
Well,
you know, is it documented somewhere that say, hey, this has been going on for quite some time, and technically, I felt, you know, she's probably in danger. I mean, she, you know, she says she kind of, you know,
I think last week she mentioned something about police, but we're never getting at that this week. But I forgot to wrap up here, Medan.
Yeah, man, easy.
All right, respect.
Daddy Road. The last time I seen you, you think I'm a woman. I mean, this man. I learned from Connecticut.
Oh.
I was listening to your program and I dead with laugh because Mr. Rod said that the rule checks you a woman.
All right, we're done.
All right.
All right, cool, Larry.
All right.
All right, well, I forgot to wrap up right now, ladies and gentlemen, but I don't know the things that are ready. Yeah.
Good night to everybody that participated.
You know,
thank you.
It's a super show, and, you know, I want to make it what it is, you know. What I would really appreciate still is if we had more persons who were brave and willing to share their experience with us like she has, because each one teaches one, right? Simple as that. So, on behalf of Cassie, the engineer, my co-host, Shelly Ann, Daddy Road saying, big up my wife for life and respect.